At Luck Defense, number 20, Manny Rowe. At Right Defense, number 9, Cameron Timor. And in the nets tonight for your Wildcats, number 35, Nolan Bivolsik. The head coach of your Wildcats is Chad Berman. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise. Gentlemen, remove your hats and face the south goal for tonight's national anthem played by Arizona Hockey's own organ player, Mike Davis. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Davis.
Your referee for tonight's contest is Tom.
All right, welcome into Tucson Arena. Tom Callahan here, Will Harmon. We are getting ready to go for tonight's game as the Arizona Wildcats once again hosting Western Michigan University. Second game, second day in a row, the same two teams yesterday. Arizona jumped out to a 3-0 lead halfway through the first. But by the time we actually got around to the final score, it was 5-3. Both teams, Will, I think, had advantages at times. And clearly Western Michigan playing a physical game and clogging things up a little, that's when they were successful. Arizona, when they were using their speed game, that's when they were successful.
Yeah, two different really bright spots for them. I know that there's a lot of things that both teams probably were interested in trying to work on here. But, a 5-3 win for Arizona. The bright spots for them, that penalty kill, like we had mentioned, Turo in net as well, had a big game, and that balanced scoring that we talked about as well. We do have some goal scoring changes. I'm not quite sure of those at the moment, but again, a balanced scoring for this team, and moving forward for Western Michigan as well. That second and third period were way stronger than their first period. Obviously, that was something that. We had spoke with the Western Michigan players a little bit about. That's something that they've had an issue with this season as well. So it's not just the issue of Arizona. That's something that Western Michigan is trying to get out to a quick start as well.
Well, let's see if Arizona can get out to one here as they try to apply pressure. 40 seconds into this first period. And they're already cycling through a change here. There's a centering feed that did not get through. Westland over to the far side after it. And a centering feed knocked away in front. Over to the far side. So Bailey Marshall back taking a regular shift here tonight after being limited in action last night, giving it a full go this evening. Stallions chasing it down to Wildcats end. Played back up the near side by Hedgecoke. Tied up on the half wall. Arizona will look up the left wing ear's hole, and he chips it off the glass and down the ice. Arizona still chasing. Hole in pursuit. Johansson tried to cut it off. That hit a shin. Stays in. On the left half boards. Fed to the right point. Here's Holt. He's up a drive, and he hit his own man in front. Puck kept into the line. Into the right side corner. Johansson spins away from a check. To the dot. Cutting in front. Shot tipped down low, but Larson couldn't get it to go. On to the far side, Lowell. Johansson in the pile. Larson took a big run at one of the Western Michigan players. That was Olsen. Puck out and a long shot. That misses the net. And Bivolsik in net tonight for Arizona. It was Juro last night who, as you said, boy, Will, did he come up big in a couple of spots and really kind of bailed this Wildcat team out.
Yeah, I mean, they kind of got caught puck watching a little bit there for certain stretches of the game. And like we said, it is always solid to have a goaltender like Juro. Again, Bivolsik, a very strong goaltender as well, pretty common for the coaching staff to kind of rotate those guys throughout the season. So nothing against Turo or anything like that or how he played yesterday. It's just more of just kind of mixing up the guys a little bit.
And the puck out of play in the Western Michigan end. And we will have a draw here with 2:22 gone in the first period. Scoreless so far. Not quite the hot start Arizona got off to yesterday. Three goals in the first 10 minutes, and then they kind of took their foot off the gas a little.
Yeah, if they have the momentum going for like they did last night, to have three goals going for them right away, that's something that they're going to be trying to do again here. Get the scoring going early, get the pucks on net early. And really be working hard on that forecheck to keep the puck in the zone.
Western Michigan will move the puck ahead here. And a wrist shot misses the net. Out to center, Arizona trying to push two on two. Meyer chasing into the right side corner. Dawson Marshall behind the net to help him out. Meyer, left side, that puck kept alive by Decker. And now it ends up out at center. Stallions pushing back in. Ford trying to weave his way through the D for a chance, couldn't pull it off. We talked about Wyatt Ford a lot before yesterday's game, a guy who came in tied for ninth in ACHA scoring, and a quiet night. They did a nice job keeping him off the sheet, not necessarily his line, but maybe you wonder if he's going to try to be a little bit more involved. I know he was shaken up in the game yesterday. You wonder if that played a part in it.
Yeah, obviously he's a guy we highlighted, a very strong, skilled player for Western Michigan. And again, he's had points in all but only four games now, like if you add in last night. A guy who has so much scoring ability and just creates so many scoring chances for this team. Definitely a guy that they're going to have to lock up to really kind of buoy that defense, or that offense, I should say, of Western Michigan.
Stallions put themselves offside at the Arizona line. Wildcats regroup. Hole flips it in near corner. Backhanded around by Sulin. Puck still not out. Quick turnaround shot. Bird missed the net. Right point hole tried to blast it through traffic. It went off a shin pad and out. Both teams working on a change here. 4:10 gone in the first. Scoreless draw thus far, but Arizona's had the bulk of the chances. They're looking to generate another one here on the right side. And tied up on the wall. Westling can't keep it down there. Now way to center. Western Michigan in offside. A little shoulder contact there between Hedgecoke and Olinger. And, you know, Will, the other thing we wondered in talking about before this game started was how much of the physical stuff was going to carry over. It doesn't look like much so far.
Yeah, no, just a couple hits here there. Pretty common, though, for both for Arizona. You know, they like to kind of come out and throw a few. But, you know, it's been pretty standard so far. I think maybe these guys are just kind of waiting to kind of feel each other out and see how this game's going to go.
All right, now the Stallions trying to push the attack. A shot, and Bobulsek with the blocker save. Westland able to clear it out. Here's Marshall trying to send it across. Pass deflected out of the zone. And now big check thrown, but well, the zone was never cleared. Cusinelli came towards the blue line, and now he's got a little bit of something to say to the bench there. But Cusinelli came to the blue line, and instead of tagging up and resuming the attack, just stayed inside the zone, and we get the whistle. Not quite 5 minutes gone here in the first. Arizona, Western Michigan. And a good shoulder there at center. Thrown by Concannon, seeing some action here for only the second time this season. A long dump down the ice, ends up in an icing call against the Wildcats. It's odd that, Will, so far tonight feels more like a feeling out process. I thought that might have happened yesterday, but it feels like tonight is the feeling out process so far.
Yeah, it feels like a completely different game, if I'm being honest. You know, 24 hours later, just, you know, kind of a big changeup. I think both teams have kind of settled in here, and especially for Western Michigan coming on the road, they feel a little bit more comfortable, I would say, you know, not, you know, coming out flat-footed like they did yesterday.
Arizona pushing the attack once again. And a wraparound try there. Boy, I'll tell you what, Johansson loves that play. He got a goal off it yesterday, but couldn't get it there. Johansson will try to stuff it in front one more time. Ends up behind the net. Backhand pass picked off. And Western Michigan dispossessed at center by Rowe. Rowe stepping in around the falling defenseman. Rowe had it poked away. Great second effort by Siwula. Boy, oh boy, Siwula saved what would have been basically a 3-on-1 from the hash marks with that second effort diving poke check. Arizona does push ahead again, though. Puck at the right point, a shot blocked, ends up on the right half wall. And fake on the one-timer now, Rister. That one is tipped in behind the net. Alex Hufford getting the nod again in net tonight for Western Michigan. And survived that first 10 minutes where he gave up the three goals there, and two of them were big rebounds. After that, I thought he settled down pretty well.
Yeah, if he, that's something the Wildcats should be looking for here, maybe a bigger rebound, try and capitalize on those opportunities again. But again, that also kind of goes back to the defense of Western Michigan, though, not being able to clear those pucks out.
Forward in with a break, a chance, and getting over Bivolsik with the save. The rebound is swept wide on the third effort. Boy, the quick break there by Ford. He didn't get much on it, but the off-speed pitch was actually more difficult to handle, I think, for the goaltender.
A great save from Bivolsik. A puck right out in front, kind of one of those rebounds that we were just talking about and mentioning, but this time on the Arizona side, a great save from Bivolsik, tracked it all the way, and that was a great scoring chance there for Western Michigan.
Well, Arizona doesn't want to rely on their goaltenders too much, but it's nice to know that when they do, they come up big. Faceoff will be to the left of the Wildcats cage. Arizona winning the draw, they'll play it around. Out through center now, a break in behind the D. There's a shot, shoulder save made by Hufford. What a job there by Olsen to cut in behind and get that chance off. Cleared the other way, but Western Michigan will dump it in. Changing the D behind the play, but they keep the forecheck strong. Arizona able to move it out though. Artizone playing it into the left wing corner, chasing it down himself. Puck behind the net. Out the near wing, backhanded along to center. 7.5 gone to the first, scoreless, Western Michigan and Arizona. By this point in yesterday's contest, we had a couple of goals. And not surprised, too, to see Western Michigan trying to play it a little closer to the vest here. Long shot in front, tipped wide. Marshall will feed it back to the left point. There's another wrister through traffic. Oh, nice save as the puck hopped up there on Hufford. He will glove it and hang on. So the Stallions, I don't know if this start is better or worse, except in terms of the scoreboard for them. They're still giving up the chances. They're just not giving up the goals like they did early on yesterday.
Yeah, obviously much happier with what the score is right now compared to what yesterday's was. Right around now is when we kind of saw that flurry of goals going for Arizona. For them to be in this game still, you know, right at the top, that's something that they're going to be pretty happy with, considering, you know, the rough start they had yesterday.
Arizona trying to follow through on their checks here. Before this game, and we have heard Chad Berman saying after the last couple of games about how he was just still not quite happy with the effort and feels like almost like his team was getting away with things, icing against Arizona. Well, today they held a players-only meeting, and the players defined what they felt their goals should be for this team and tried to put that down. And a lot of them were along the lines of, you know, the attributes you would expect, you know, you have to work hard, you have to take responsibility, those sort of things. But it's interesting that, so the players decided to take the matters into their own hands and have that meeting today, obviously after harping from their coach. Interesting to see how that's going to play out, not only in this game, but as the rest of the season works its way through.
Yeah, it's good to have a team that kind of has the accountability like that, to call a meeting and just kind of, even just on that, just kind of get on the same page, air out whatever needs to be aired out, you know, just kind of just talk about things that you know, maybe are on just on your mind, not even necessarily hockey related either, you know, just kind of get all those skeletons out of the closet almost, just kind of almost like a therapy session, you know, just trying to clear your head, get on the right page. And the thing is, you know, we've highlighted the consistency and how they haven't quite played to the level that they're capable of playing for most of the season. But again, they are 12-2-2, and for them to still have that record shows just how talented they are to you know, not have these put these consistent games together, or consistent periods and shifts together, and still be able to have a 12-2-2 record, you know, right around the halfway mark here. It's good to see that they're still going to be in it, and if they fine-tune what they need to fine-tune, this team's going to be tough to beat.
It's kind of that double-edged sword where if you're getting away with it, sometimes you think nothing's wrong. Well, if you realize that you can always improve, you can always do things better, and it's not so much what can we get away with as opposed to how can we really just take the other teams out and continue to step on them when they're down. Puck out of play with 10:04 to go here in the first, scoreless between Arizona and Western Michigan. And Ethan Stahl, you not in the lineup tonight. Left yesterday in the third period of the game. Walked off under his own power. No update on what the situation is with him, but not in the lineup tonight. And for Arizona, kind of interesting. They're really testing the depth a little bit here at this point. I mean, everybody goes through injuries and bumps and bruises, and you know, the Wildcats are no exception. Certainly feeling those right now. Puck at center as Meyer tried to catch up with it. Sent back in behind the Wildcats net. Hole spins away from one. Up the right side. Meyer flips it out off the glass. Bouncing puck. They say played with a high stick. And so we'll get a whistle. 9:33 left to go here in the opening frame. They're going to put the faceoff all the way back in the Western Michigan end. Meyer in for the draw. One away into the corner. Stallions trying to clear. They do. Played back off the dasher. Certainly a little more hitting to this point of the hockey game than there was yesterday. And again, Western Michigan, one of the teams that, you know, they probably are playing better and sharper when they're physical, but also prone to being a little undisciplined at times. Although I thought they actually held their temper pretty well yesterday, especially towards the end of the game, and netted them an extended 5-on-3. They just couldn't convert. Artizon trying to move up the right wing side. Meyer following the play. Wrister to the net, blocked. Stallions the other way. Up the right wing side, carrying in a centering feed way too far in front of Zappa. Santa tried to put it in front. That one is blocked away. Artizon the right wing. Knocks his man down. Couldn't come up with a puck, however, as it drifts in over the line. Chipped towards the slot. Not cleared back out. Sent right back in by Artizon. And now moving up on the forecheck, Duke Litwin getting the nod in the lineup here tonight, wearing number 32 for your Wildcats. Western Michigan back the other way. Freiberg off the glass out to center. 2-on-2 developing. Westland trying to feed it across. And turning around, puck, interesting, turned into a pass off the back dasher, but Westland couldn't get a shot away. Now chasing the puck is Litwin at center, forcing the turnover. Rowe quickly back in transition. And here's Litwin in again. His shot hit a shin pad, forced across by Westland. Bouncing puck hopped over the stick of Timor. Back on the right wing side, pushing is Rivette into the far corner, leaving it off on the wall over there for Maddalena. Marshall trying to poke it out. Interesting, too, right now. A little bit of shuffling of the lines here by Chad Berman, Will. And when you get so many new names and numbers in the lineup, I mean, you try to figure out where these guys might fit.
Yeah, especially with some of those injuries that we had mentioned as well. You know, just switching things up, just trying to get a different groove going for how everything's going. You know, just the simple things like that, just maybe just kickstart a line that maybe some surprising production might come from there, or just some energy shifts come from certain guys who aren't usually playing together, that all of a sudden something clicks.
Stallions back on the rush, flipping into the left wing corner of the Arizona end. Clearing attempt went off a helmet. And the Wildcats push up the right side. Bailey Marshall looking in front, gets it across, tipped, and that one did not connect on the back door. It went past Rowe, and Marshall couldn't get his stick on it. It was a good scoring chance right there that goes by the boards for the Wildcats. And they'll push it up the right wing again. They really are generating off the transition game, though, so far. Generating off the rush as well. Here's Johansson, tried to squeak one up top, pass blocked. Out the far side, Lowell to the left point, shot deflected away. Johansson on it behind the net, wraps it in front, and he's met with the left pad of Hufford. Western Michigan going back the other way. Long wrister missed the net, forward centering. Backhand chance, that one is blocked. Nice job by Hedgecock to get in the way. Johansson in the near corner, sends it around the glass, and it stays up in the dasher for a moment, rolls out of the zone. Well, Arizona needs a change, they're gonna try to complete that here. Dumped in, and Bobolsik will elect to play it back around towards that left point area, pushed out to center, puck free there, went into the body of Adams, he'll pull it back down, send it to the D. Western Michigan regrouping, Aaron pass there, but it does not result in icing. They were trying to get through the change while in possession, but turned over to Arizona, 5:05 to go in the first. Still looking for the first goal in this one. A much more measured pace here this evening. Now Meyer cuts in over the line, but unfortunately, Dawson Marshall was in ahead of him. Offside, 4:56 to go. So still trying to figure out who's going to land with whom on the lines. Decker and Meyer have been together, and now Dawson Marshall on the left side here. Meyer winning the faceoff back. Tried to send that one in deep. Cut off at the line, and Decker cutting in with a shot. Save made by Hufford, and he absorbs the rebound. One of the better chances for either side, I think, in this first period.
Yeah, chances kind of hard to come by right now, and you got to take advantage of any opportunity you can. And this feels like, so far, one of those games where just throw it on net. Maybe it takes a deflection. Maybe a puck takes a weird bounce.
Western Michigan looking for a chance to clear the zone here, and they do. Concannon on the right side, tipped in by Meyer. Marshall up on the forecheck. Dawson Marshall pinning Santa onto the wall. Trying to pull the puck out of the pile. Comes up the boards. Away come the Stallions to center. They'll dump it in from there. Bobolsik trying to play it along. Forecheck pressure, forcing a turnover in the near side. I think Arizona was a little too nonchalant there coming back. Freiberg back the other way. Wildcats pressing on the right side. Bird feeding it behind the net. Artizone trying to get to it. Played around to Madalena, and he'll just get it out to center. Wildcats put it back in. Back off the glass, and again to center. We're saying this a lot. It's a lot of pitch and catch in the neutral zone here in this first period.
Yeah, big neutral zone battle, and that's kind of one of the things that Arizona was doing well at yesterday. You know, some of the physicality and just kind of the neutral zone battles yesterday, I think Western Michigan's a little bit up to the task here today, especially in this first period compared to yesterday.
Here's Rowe trying to lead the forecheck on the right side. Stepping up on the play here, still keeping the puck in the zone. Now finally it's knocked free, ends up down the left wing side into the corner, chased by Olsen. He's rubbed off on the boards, chipped off the glass to the point, not out. That one is kept in by Koslakavich. And away come the Wildcats. Lead pass on the right side. I don't think Westland was expecting that. Koslakavich will swing it around to the far side. Now we'll get it back on the near wall. Chipped past Hole and out to center. 2:39 to go in the first. Arizona and Western Michigan scoreless here. Much tighter hockey game on a Saturday night. Westland stepping in, rolling puck. Wrist shot tipped out of play.
Hey, Wildcat fans, be sure to join us on Thursday, November 21st. That's next Thursday. at 7:30 p.m.
So if we do get a goal ever in this one, and I say that kind of tongue-in-cheek because of the three-goal first period outburst we had yesterday, and we ended up with a 5-3 final, both these teams scoring quite a bit. I'm a little surprised that we haven't had one yet.
Chances aren't necessarily coming all that easily either for either team, and you know, we just saw Western kind of skate through there, and Western Michigan is doing a really good job getting their sticks in front of some of these shots and just kind of deflecting the puck out to where when you do have those opportunities, they're doing well just to close those out.
Puck is tied up in the far side corner of the Western Michigan end. And they'll play it ahead, but oh, that play way offside. Ford tried to dump it in and just fanned on it, so he peels back. Now they'll try it again. That third effort, finally the puck is in, but the Stallions had to tag up. That allows the Wildcats a chance to break out, but the pass missed at center. Ford trying to skate through some traffic, lost it to Larson. That one is dumped in, and now the stick slashed out of the hands there of Johansson, and now it was played away from him while he was trying to retrieve it. Maybe the slash you don't call, but I was kind of surprised the sweeping of the stick away from him wasn't. That's usually an unsportsmanlike. Back the other way, a shot and a long wrist shot results in a goal. Siwula goes high stick side on Bavolsik with 1:21 to go in the first, and Western Michigan grabs the lead.
One of those goals we were talking about last night as well, 1:21 left in the period. Complete momentum shift, especially when, you know, it's been generally a neutral zone battle here, and, you know, just an absolute snipe from the point almost. And, you know, Savula's playing some good hockey here these last 2 days. Picked up an assist yesterday, captain of this team for Western Michigan, a guy who, you know, really can bring it. We saw him getting in front of some of the shots on the defensive end, and now he went the other way and put one in the back of the net for him.
Bavolsik came out but dropped, and that shot beat him high over the right shoulder.
Corey Siwula. That's Siwula, unassisted. Time of the goal, 18 minutes, 39 seconds in the first period.
And so the team that breaks through first, Western Michigan. Now to the final minute of play here in the opening frame. Wildcats trying to press. Puck at center. Turned over here. Arizona having a little bit of trouble moving the puck back up the ice. And boy, you hope on this last shift before the intermission, this is where you want to push back right now if you're Arizona.
This is where they're going to find out a lot about their team right now, especially with some of the consistency issues we had mentioned. This team has shown resiliency in the past, but again, almost halfway through the season here now, you know, this next 30 seconds here, how you close out the period after giving up a goal is going to be huge.
Meyer in front, a shot and a save made on Dawson Marshall, and he takes a two-hander in front as he was parked in front of Hufford.
Probably the best chance of the game so far for Arizona, shot right in front. Hufford did well.
Now Hufford has been square to the puck tonight. He's been absorbing those pucks pretty well. Marshall did what he was supposed to do, get to the front of the net. Hufford gave me a real solid chop to the shins. I think they'll just file it away under Boys Will Be Boys here with 23.7 to go in the first. Nice to see the Wildcats generate a scoring chance, though, after kind of stumbling around in the neutral zone a little bit there. Bailey Marshall out there now, and well, we can't drop the puck yet. Hufford is adjusting his gear. Ready for the draw to his left. Won by Arizona. There's a chance. That one is blocked. Puck towards the net, and Hufford covers. Cousinelli cutting across. A little bit of a set play there off the faceoff.
Yeah, that's one of those set plays we've seen a little bit this season. You know, he starts off on the right side there and then just kind of skates into the slot. Arizona has a lot of these set plays off of faceoffs, and those, they take a lot of scoring chances from those set plays.
Like at the right point. Swung over to the left side, time winding down to the period, down to 12 seconds. Westland feeding it behind the net. Cousinelli trying to put it in front. It goes around, left point row. Hanging on, long shot, deflected away in front. Marshall on the off wing, centered, and it got through traffic. And time expires in the first period. So the Wildcats with a little flurry there towards the end. but unable to put the puck in the net. And so the Wildcats head off towards the intermission. I don't think that's necessarily the period you pictured for Arizona here coming out, especially at home on a Saturday night. Pretty good crowd on hand. But Western Michigan's going to be a tough out, and I think they showed that in the opening 20 minutes.
Yeah, they came out ready to play, and, you know, before the game, we came up to our press box, and Western Michigan's coach was actually sitting up here. You know, he was studying film, and they were going over a lot of certain things that they were doing yesterday that they want to improve on. And one of those things absolutely was their first period and how they came out flat and gave up three goals right away. Obviously, they came back here and cleaned that up. For Arizona, a couple shifts were at the end here, even though, you know, they are down one, where they were generating a lot better scoring chances than they were at the onset of the game. And, you know, for Arizona, a team who has so much talent that we talk about and the issues that we have talked about throughout the season about consistency, well now you're down one and you have two periods of hockey left to try and come back and just really bring the fight back to Western Michigan. This is a huge game, I think. You know, it's not a WCHL game, but it's a huge game for Arizona because, you know, you're trying to fine-tune all these things from yesterday. You know, you got the win yesterday. How do they come back out and take advantage of some of their scoring chances and really try and come out and bring the fight at home with a home crowd here?
Well, if you are going to talk about consistency, you've got to beat teams that you should beat night in, night out, and you've got to bring that effort all three periods, all 60 minutes. And cliches, yes, but they're cliches for a reason. It's because there's truth in them. And so I think that's what Arizona's going to look for here, consistency of effort for the next two periods. But right now, they trail 1-0, not a big deficit for Western Michigan, and the goal was a long-range shot. I'm sure Pavalsic would like that one back, but they're going to have to find a little more push in period number two. So, all right, well, we'll step into the intermission here with Western Michigan leading Arizona 1-0, 20 minutes in. We'll come back with more in just a moment. The first intermission report is next on Arizona Wildcats Hockey.
I'm Timothy Gasson. They call me the AZ Puck Man. I've been following hockey at the University of Arizona for more than 30 years. And this is my Wildcat Hockey Report.
Welcome back to the Wildcat Hockey Report. I'm with Nolan Pavalsic, goaltender for the Arizona Wildcats. And Nolan, first of all, this is going to be your junior year here. Can you talk a little bit about your development from your freshman year to now? You're becoming a more complete hockey player. What has helped you in your development as a goaltender here at the U of A?
Well, my freshman year, obviously, I was more of a third-string goalie, trying to make my way into second string. Working on just really getting my routine down and really just getting set during practice and stuff. And when I got the opportunity to play, I was obviously giving my fullest effort in the game. Last year, I ended up playing a lot more games than I was expected to, and it really gave me more confidence on the ice. And then this year, I just hope to maybe take over that first string role, but definitely back up Chiro and see what we do.
Now, every hockey player goes through a lot of training, but for a goaltender, is there anything that can really replicate game action? Do you really grow as a goaltender through game action?
No, it's more of like fine tuning during the games. Practice is really where we want to focus and just kind of get set on our angles and just make sure that we're always square to the puck. But then once we get in the game, it's just really more of experiencing that practice that we've had.
So you're one of the goaltenders who believes you play as well as you practice. I've talked to goaltenders who don't like practice at all and they're saving everything for the game. But a lot of Hall of Fame goaltenders believe you play in a game as well as you practice, so you believe in that?
Yes, yeah, I do.
So do you have any set goals for this year, Nolan?
I think as a team goal, we definitely want to be at the top. Personally, I think I want to be in that top five of top goaltenders in the league and just really try to push myself and Chiro just to be the top goalies in the league.
Fabulous. Well, we've been talking with junior goaltender Nolan Pavalsic. Thanks, Nolan, and go Cats.
Thank you.
Is this another good goal? That's a beautiful tip in by Tyler Griffith. That's Ethan Staliuk with the goal. There's a shot to goal. Arizona takes the lead. Anthony Cucinelli with the backhander. He shoots. He scores! Your Arizona Wildcats, champions of the Cactus Cup!
I'm Autumn Froyland, and I'm here with Bailey Marshall. Bailey, reflecting a little bit on last season, you had a great season, 74 points, MVP, but that was last season. Now we're in this season. Are you doing anything different? What are some things that you're working on to kind of make this season almost or better than last season?
Haven't really been able to get on the ice much this summer, so really trying to focus on just getting back into the swing of things, getting my shot right, making sure that I'm getting a little more endurance. So right now I'm working on that so that I can get back into how I was doing last season.
There is another Marshall on this team. He is related to you. His name is Dawson. That is your younger brother. So talk a little bit about what it's like to have a brother on the team. Are there any rivalries? Is he in the locker room trying to, like, fight with you all the time, trying to make maybe be better? What's that all about?
Yeah, no, last year was actually our first season playing together, and it was pretty awesome. If you watch the games that me and Dawson penalty kill together a lot of the times, and we definitely do well. We mesh well out there on the penalty kill for that. Other than that, I'd say he looks up to me as a bigger brother and on the ice just to kind of try and compete with me a little bit during practice and stuff like that. But, yeah, we definitely enjoy penalty killing together, and I think we do a pretty good job of that as well.
So he obviously looks up to you. So what are some advice that you give him to kind of, you know, move on and some things that you tell him?
Just kind of like he's just got to keep working and make sure that he's playing his role and not to try and be a player that he's not. Like, he's pretty good grinding in the corners and just plays his role as a fourth line kind of guy and penalty killer really well. So just trying to try and not be anybody else and just play how he should be playing.
We've been talking with Bailey Marshall, and we will be right back with more of the Wildcat Hockey Report.
I am Will Harmon here with sophomore defenseman Matthew Hull. Matthew, pretty big season last year as a freshman. What have you done differently to try and continue that momentum going into now your sophomore year?
Mostly just my confidence, just getting used to, like, last year was pretty big stepping in, but I think this year being more confident on the blue line and just playing like I regularly do.
And you're a St. Louis guy, Stanley Cup champions last year. What would it be like for the University of Arizona Wildcats to win the championship this year?
Winning a championship would be amazing, but right now we're just focused on each game at a time, and getting to the national championship is definitely the first step. WCHL conference championship is also another step, but not really looking towards that at first, but yeah, it would definitely be amazing, yeah.
I've been with Matthew Hull, and now we are sending it back to the Wildcat Hockey Report.
It's time for another Arizona Wildcat Hockey, This or That.
Okay, I feel like this one's a little obvious. Mustache or beard?
Muzzies.
Why?
Better style, and I try to look my best.
Does anything ever get stuck?
Yeah, when I eat a sandwich, I have to, like, lift the upper lip up so I don't eat hairs.
Bench or penalty box?
As of recently, it's been penalty box.
Why?
I'm not meaning to. I've just been a little too physical.
Okay. USA or Canada?
USA.
Why?
It's where I've lived my whole life.
Friends or The Office?
The Friends.
Why?
It's the OG before The Office.
Okay. Morning or a night person?
Night.
Why?
Waking up just isn't my thing.
Warm-up time. Hello, Tucson, Arizona. Yeah. Hiya, Joe.
Yeah.
Have a good one, guys. Have a good one.
Work hard.
Gets going. Let's take a look at the south.
All right, fellas, have a good one now. Get down. Let's go. Up easy. Too many men here.
I know in the past you've talked about trying to create a cooperative atmosphere on the ice between yourself, the teams, and the coaching staffs. Talk about your approach to officiating what can be a very difficult game.
Well, certainly at this level, you've got guys that know the game and basically they know you. You've been working with them for 2, 3, 4 years and you get a rapport with them. I don't have any animosity toward anybody at this level. They know what I expect and they do their job and I do my job and everybody's happy.
Hey, let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Shut up. Shut up. So we're getting even? All right, cool. I like it.
We have 10 feet from our boards.
No, you don't.
We don't?
No.
No?
No, you have to be at the bench.
I'm sorry?
You have to be at the bench. Go 10 feet. Your goaltender does. Your goaltender's got 10 feet if you're going to pull the goaltender. Sure. Yeah, you bet. Anytime. Well, I think went rather well.
Stick down. Let's go, move it. That's all. Easy in front. I got it loose, let's go. Move it. It's loose. Nothing so far, let's go. Get a clue. You want to go for 10?
There's an escape goal by number 8, Jason.
You guys gotta start calling some of that, huh?
What's that?
Just the blatant, like when we get scoring opportunities taken away. I don't care about the tiki tack, but like cross checks in front of
that. Soft hook.
Yeah, that was a breakaway.
Can't nobody else work with us. Good period.
Up. No problem there. No problem. Let him go, 5. Good job.
How long you know me? A couple years?
Come on. Why did you come over there?
Huh?
I would never throw a guy.
I wouldn't even throw a guy. Are you kidding me? Come on, that's not enough. Knock it off.
You gotta give me a penalty. Wrong with he was screwed with our goalie, you saw it.
No, I didn't see it. I was following the puck.
Gonna beat up my friend. What was he doing?
Yeah.
That was a pretty bad cheap shot there.
Was it?
At number 7, he's the guy. Same thing last time we played.
7?
I sat out for 2 weeks because of him. Cheap shots, you know?
I'll watch him. Thanks. That was a pretty good game. Just trying to capture the spirit of the thing.
Your hometown hockey team, your Western Collegiate Hockey League champions, your Arizona Wildcats. Tickets for Arizona hockey are now on sale. Support your Wildcats as they battle ASU for another Cactus Cup championship and more at the Tucson Arena. Your hockey team, your Arizona Wildcats. Call 791-4101 for tickets now.
All right, welcome back to the Tucson Arena where Arizona Wildcats are losing 1-2-0 against Western Michigan Stallions. Our own Autumn Freeland actually caught up with Dawson Marshall before the game. Let's hear what Dawson had to say about last night and tonight as well.
Hi, I'm Autumn Freeland, and I'm here with number 10, Dawson Marshall. Dawson, you guys are taking on Western Michigan University again tonight. So you guys got to see how they played yesterday. So how does that affect how you guys plan on playing tonight?
It's really that we got the tools to beat this team, and it's really about the effort that we bring to it, and that's what we got to make sure we do. We got to win all those quarter battles and bring the puck to the net and just capitalize on all the shots and get some goals.
Now, we've been talking a little bit about consistency. So consistency is really, really important. So how do you guys make sure that every single period you play, you guys come out 100%?
Well, that's something we're struggling with right now. And, you know, it's just about in the locker room, being with the guys and just bringing it every day. And I don't know, if something's got to turn around, we're working on that right now. It's about being positive and, you know, we just got to battle hard and I think we can do it.
Awesome. We've been speaking with number 10, Dawson Marshall, and we send it back up to the booth.
All right. Thank you, Autumn. So interesting there from Dawson Marshall talking about some of those consistency issues that we have been discussing on the last couple broadcasts. So we have another interview here coming as well soon with Autumn and Austin Kozar. So he will be someone who, you know, he had a goal and an assist yesterday. We spoke with him about how they have been struggling to kind of start games. Let's hear what Austin had to say about yesterday and tonight as well.
Hi, I'm Autumn Freyland, and I'm here with Austin Kozar of Western Michigan University. Austin, you guys are taking on the Wildcats again tonight. Yesterday you had a great game. You scored a goal. Talk a little bit about it.
Yeah, just crashed the net. Defenseman Corey Sula threw the puck in the net and got a good tip on it, and luckily it found the back.
So you guys ended up being down 3 in the first. So what do you guys have to do tonight to make sure you guys are playing consistent and making sure you guys come out on top in the beginning?
We just got to come out hard. It's been a problem of ours all year, and just coming out hard in the first period, usually we get a late jump on it and got to get started from the beginning.
Awesome. We've been speaking with Austin Kozar, and we'll send it back up to the booth.
All right. Thank you, Autumn. Two more minutes here until the start of the second period. Again, you know, the consistency issues that we asked Dawson Marshall about, you know, he was kind of a guy yesterday on that line with Lowell and Alex Johansson, a line that provided a lot of different, you know, energy moments for the Wildcats yesterday when they needed them. They'll need Dawson Marshall again tonight to be able to pick up some of the slack there as far as energy goes. A guy who I also will be keeping my eye on is Manny Rowe, a guy who works hard almost every single shift and a guy who is one of the leaders of this team, really going to be able to, you know, push the tempo, have some energy shifts, pick up some big hits. And for the rest of the Wildcats, too, those neutral zone battles are really the story of the game so far here. I think as far as the consistency thing goes, you know, not too many mistakes necessarily from them. Just not really generating a lot of goal scoring opportunities.
Well, I think that's one of the biggest things you're going to look for the Wildcats to try to correct in period number 2. And, you know, one of the things that kind of struck me there was there were a couple of moments where I felt some energy and enthusiasm, but for the most part, it was almost a going through the motion. I called it a feeling out process early in that period, but as it continued on and the emotion didn't build, the energy didn't build, I was a little surprised by that. And again, here and there, there'd be a big hit there. There was a scoring chance there, but it wasn't consistent at all. And I really look for the energy level of this Wildcats hockey team to go up tenfold in period number 2.
Yeah, the first 5 minutes of this period, I think, are going to be absolutely crucial. Again, we talked about it leading into the intermission. A really huge game right now for Arizona. You know, again, no WCHL implications necessarily, but you know, how do they respond being down 1-0, considering all of the issues that we have highlighted the last two nights? Look for the captains, look for the experienced leaders of this team to really try and bring the energy level up every single shift, make sure the guys are working hard. This first 5 minutes is going to be huge.
And again, just want to mention for those of you who might be looking for Tim Gasson, wearing this headset, I'm filling in for Tim. Well, Tim is out of commission for a little bit, but Tim, get well soon. We look forward to having you back on board soon. So from the entire Arizona broadcast crew, we wish you a speedy return. And we wish Arizona a speedy trip to the goal-scoring podium here, if they can pop one in. But Western Michigan able to alleviate the pressure again. It's interesting, too, Western Michigan hasn't clogged the neutral zone up as much, and that was something that, there's a turnover down low, shot off the goalpost. Turned over down low to Matthews, and he just walked right in with it.
Oh boy, well, that's not what you want to start a period with there. Careless giveaway in your own zone, and a game really where you can't be doing that. You can't be handing chances to the other team when they are so scarce.
Oh boy, I mean, handed to him on a platter right there at the dot. Oof. He beat Bavolsek. He just didn't beat the net, hit the post. Puck is tossed back out to neutral ice. Pass missed Larson. Wildcats had to tag up there and try to resume the forecheck, but already the puck has broken the zone. Johansson trying to turn it back the other way. And the hitting picking up a little bit here, unfortunately, there. As Larson went to throw the hit, he ran more into Johansson than anybody else. But those are the worst, the friendly fire. Hole with a pass through center. Johansson cuts in over the line in the slot. A shot and a blocker save there for Hufford. Johansson near corner. Chasing to the far side. Johansson looking to cut in front, a jam side of the net, Hufford save. He gets pushed into the net, but he had the puck covered, and now here we go. Now this is a little bit of the fire I was talking about, Will. This is a little bit more what you need to see out of this Wildcats hockey team, and Josh Larson has provided it probably more than anybody else, I think, so far.
Yeah, and last night we saw that as well. He had a couple of huge hits last night. Again, that's something that, you know, especially when you're down 1-0, every single tiny little knock, every single tiny little check is going to just bother you that much more. It's going to make you try and, you know, really pick up the energy level for the whole team. It can spark something, but obviously you don't want to, you know, pick up a roughing call or anything like that. But, again, you do like to kind of see that, from, especially from a guy like Larson, who we saw it so much from last night as well.
Faceoff will be to the left of the Western Michigan goal. Buck 59 gone here in the second period. Western Michigan with a 1-0 lead that came from a long-range wrister by Siwula. With just under 2 minutes to go in the first, there's a shot towards the net. Johansson looking for the tip, and again, pushing and shoving in front. Now a glove punch thrown there by Matthews, and it's getting a little feisty. But I don't mind that, especially from the Wildcat perspective. I think you need to see that.
Yeah, and something else you need to see as well is kind of those shots from the point. You know, a great chance there. Johansson tried to get a little tip on there, but Hufford saw it all the way. But again, you know, creating a scoring chance, especially from a shot from the point, that's something that Arizona has done really well this season, and you expect to see that a little bit more of that tonight.
Good forecheck effort here. And I'll tell you what, since Litwin has touched the ice, every time he's out there, boy, his legs are churning. You like to see that. But back comes Western Michigan on the left side. A little leave on the wall. Chip towards the circle. Shot and Bavolsek. A left pad save on that backhand by Farkas. And now Farkas gets drilled into the glass. Crowd like that one. Wildcats trying to move it ahead. Santa dumping it back into the Wildcats' end. Arizona facing three men on the forecheck pressure, but nice job to evade there. Hole up the right side, chipping it ahead. Litwin trying to chase it down. And he does keep it in the corner. Up the right side wall, trying to cut in front of Lowell. Lowell into the slot, couldn't get his shot away. But boy, I was surprised Jesse Lowell got that far. Now Ford tried to toe drag through the legs, didn't work. Return pass, chance up on the right side. Cutting to the wing, a backhand, and that one is wide of the net. Lowell maybe should have tried an earlier shot. Puck jammed at the side of the goal. Meyer can't get it to go. And the goal light goes on. Does Hufford have it? Or is it in? That is an Arizona Wildcats goal. Hufford fires the puck out to center in disgust. That is a goal, and here come the Teddy Bears. I kind of saw the referee point really low at the net. The goal light went on. They jammed at it, Will, at the side of the net. From our angle, couldn't see the puck. It looked like Hufford maybe had it covered, but the goal light goes on, and indeed, the referee did then signal goal.
Yeah, the goalie had, or excuse me, the line referee there had saw that one all the way. That was kind of the goal I was expecting. You know, one of those, just kind of jam plays, just trying. Push it past Hufford, who, you know, did well. I would say, you know, we didn't quite see the puck go in from our end, but again, that's the kind of thing where the scoring chances aren't necessarily coming. That was, you know, you expect when you're down 1-0 and scoring chances aren't really coming. Sometimes those goals usually are either a tip in front, a kind of a sloppy rebound, or what, like what we just saw there, kind of just a broken chance, really, where you just kind of shove the puck in there and hope for the best. And fortunately for the Wildcats, they are on the board. Good to see those teddy bears out there as well.
Absolutely. And I love the tradition of the teddy bear toss. And in my minor league days and even in the collegiate ranks, you see it in junior hockey. Always a fun thing for the fans to be able to bring a stuffed animal or two or three or ten. Some folks come in with a bag full and they toss them onto the ice when the goal is scored. And you know what? It's a nice way to give back. There's a narwhal on the ice. That's a new one. But boy, there's an awful lot of stuff out there. It's a pretty good number of stuffed animals out there, so it's good to see.
I was going to say, for the amount of people in the building, the teddy bear count out there was pretty impressive, I must say. Definitely some guys I saw coming in with bags full of them as well. Just always a great cause as well. It's great to see.
Well, you know what? I mean, it sneaks up on you every year, but here we are back around the holidays again. You know, Christmas, New Year's, American Thanksgiving, and you know, there are kids in need out there who may not have the best opportunities at Christmas. And so these stuffed animals really go a long way towards making them feel better. So they're almost done. I think we've got them all off the ice here. Just about, as they get swept out the Zamboni doors. Speaking from experience, the worst part about this is making sure you dry them all out. Especially if the goal happens early in the period when the ice is still wet. Oh, that's a tough one. But it looks like we have all the animals up. And I still don't know who scored the goal, so we're going to have to wait for the announcement here because there were a couple of Wildcats in the area jamming away at it. I can tell you it comes at the 3:14 mark of the period, so nice to get the early goal. And, Will, I think that is very important.
Definitely getting that goal right back. You don't want Western Michigan to get that next goal and go up 2-0 because – you know, not you're just digging a deeper hole for yourself.
Wildcat teddy bear toss goal. Give it to number 27, Max Meyer. The assist goes to number 33, Wes Freiberg, and number 10, Dawson Marshall. That's Meyer from Freiberg and Marshall. Time of your Wildcat goal, 3 minutes, 14 seconds in the first period, second period.
We are indeed in the second period. The game now tied up at one. Interesting to see, and you know, the one downside to the teddy bear toss when the home team does score the goal is it does kill whatever momentum you might have got off the goal. But let's see, maybe the next couple of shifts, what each team brings. And I'm really curious to see if Arizona can keep its energy up.
Yeah, and Dawson Marshall, a guy who we spoke with after the break there as well, one of the guys who had a lot of good shifts yesterday as far as forechecking and just overall just put in a lot of good shifts. And for him to get on the score sheet there, great to see him, you know, kind of rewarded for the work that he's doing out there.
And now Western Michigan with a chance in front. That puck out is tipped by Meyer. Nice job to get the stick in the lane there and deflect potential scoring chance away. Here's Freiberg with some time to roam up the middle of the ice. He'll skate it in, chip it to the left side. Dawson Marshall, left wing corner. He's pinned up on the boards. Puck to the line, escapes, and is turned back in, but rushing it on ahead is Adams. Adams to the line, lost it. Bird. Left wing Freiberg. He takes a shoulder, can't get it out. Turnaround chance, Bavulsic the save. Puck stays in the near side corner. And fans getting into it a little bit more here, Will. Always nice to have the atmosphere up, but here comes our first penalty of the game. Bavulsic out for the touch and the whistle, a roughing call, the indication. Wondered how long it would take us to see our first power play in the contest, and it belongs to Western Michigan.
Again, one of the highlights that we've discussed, that penalty kill from Arizona, so strong. But, you know, we were talking about the crowd energy here as well. That first period was almost dead silent. you know, to have the crowd be engaged and interacting like they are, I obviously don't like to see a penalty picked up, but, you know, that's what those big hits can do. And getting the crowd into it as well always is going to be a tough thing for, an opposing team who's already on the road.
Con Cannon into the box, roughing. Western Michigan to the power play. Against an Arizona penalty kill, averaging about 95% on the year, which is just absolutely astounding. There's a shot tipped on a play in front of Bavulsic as Santa let it go. We'll get a fresh biscuit into play here. 5:07 gone here in the second, tied up at 1. In the first period for Western Michigan, it was Siwula Meyer here in the second for the Wildcats. Puck is picked up on the dot, hard pass to the point, and actually put it out over the line, so a nice break for Arizona. That one is swung right out of play. Farkas wanted to use the glass and just lifted it too much. Wada down there directing traffic before the draw, but he doesn't win it. Timor skips it around, hits a stanchion, bounces down the ice, and now race up the right side. Meyer trying to get there into the corner. He does, steals it, moves it behind the net, pass into the slot, and that one is tipped away before Westling could get a shot away. Now led back by Ford. Quickly on the left side, now he'll slow it down, and it's picked away, and a breakaway chance here for the Wildcats. Cutting ahead, forehand, backhand, shot, score! Max Meyer puts it away! Shorthanded goal for the Wildcats, and they lead it 2-1.
Excellent, excellent shift from Max Meyer. He was going up and down, created that first chance as well where he tried to feed it out front to Westland. Meyer did excellent work to get back onto the penalty kill there, and then to take the puck away from Ford to lead to that breakout chance. Absolutely unbelievable. Great goal from Meyer.
This is second of the night for number 27, Max Meyer. That's Meyer, unassisted time of your Wildcat shorthanded goal. 5 minutes, 49 seconds in the second period.
Well, not only does Meyer have two tonight, he is the only player on the Wildcats with a shorthanded goal this year. That is his second. And boy, it couldn't come at a better time because now the crowd is even louder. Now everybody's really into it as the Wildcats fling it down the ice again. And Will, he had a chance right before that too. He had to go all the way up and down 200 feet, still had the energy and buries that chance. Boy, oh boy, I tell you what, that was a great penalty killing shift out of Max Meyer and company.
Yeah, and we were talking about who's gonna be that guy that's gonna step up, who whether
Dawson
he's a-
Marshall tried to put it in front, and I'll tell you what, right there, I thought Hufford was gonna get caught out of the net. If Marshall put it on goal, that might've gone in.
Yeah, Hufford was beat there. He was out of the goal. It was a wide open net there for Dawson for just a hot minute there. But, you know, again, going back to Max Meyer here, a guy who, you know, we were talking about who's going to be the guy to step up, some of the older veterans of the team, some of the guys who have been here for a while, you know, even some of the newer guys, maybe energy shifts from some of the new guys like Timor. But, you know, Max Meyer is that guy tonight, and not just on the scoreboard. Again, we had mentioned what a great penalty kill shift all around. To go up and down twice, generate scoring chances, and then do the work on the defensive end, too, to create that chance for himself.
Puck goes out of play on the far side, and Arizona out there hustling. They have, by the way, killed off the power play and scored a shorthanded goal to boot, so now they're up 2-1. And let's see, and we talked about trying to keep that energy up after the teddy bear toss goal. Well, you end up shorthanded, not where you want to be, but boy, the momentum swing of a shorthanded goal is massive. Timor letting the puck go to Rowe back inside the Wildcats end. Timor trying the right wing side. Tipped ahead just a little too far there for Johansson. Sent back in to the Arizona end. A feed up the right side, and that one is knocked away from Lowell, who was tripped down to the play. Back the other way, got the Wildcats. Up on the left wing side, curling, waiting for some help is Rowe. Rowe will fire it to the right side corner.
He'll head off the ice on the change here. Johansson tried to come up the wall with it and is able to win the battle, keep it in. Puck into the slot, and Larson reaching back for it, couldn't come up with it, but now Lowell, side of the net, and no, Huffer couldn't come up with it. Play continues. Johansson on the right side, looking to move it up top. Shot coming, blocked in the slot. Rebound chance, and a right pad save, Hufford. Sent back down, and Western Michigan needs to exhale after that shift. Wildcats right back in. There's a wrist shot missing on the glove side by Olson. Ford in transition, feeds it to the left side. Carrying it wide, Farkas sends it to the front of the net. Freiburg trying to knock it away. Bird reversing that one around to Concannon on the far side, but it ends up back with Farkas. Concannon again off the glass, still not out. Kept in, nice job of the left point there by Adams, keeping the play alive, still not out. What a board battle, Adams driving down the left side. Try to get it into the corner, pops up in the air, ends up in the slot. And now a slashing call. That's going to go against Arizona. I'll tell you what, if you didn't call the one in the first period when Johansson had his stick knocked out of his hands, you can't call that one. Or you got to call them both. But that was the exact same play one period later.
Yeah, the thing is, though, it was just a clear slash there. Again, Western Michigan, you know, we saw them kind of scrambling in the defensive end there for several minutes. Arizona doing well to keep it in their zone. But we just saw that same thing from Western Michigan there, you know, kind of a bouncing puck there, hopped over the stick of Coley Olson. And unfortunate again, we have to see that penalty kill. But again, one of the bright spots for the team this season has been how good this penalty kill is.
Well, and now they've got another shorthanded goal, too. See if Western Michigan changes anything here on the power play. There's a shot right in on Bobulsik and no rebound. Saw that one all the way. Nice job by the Wildcats in front of the net. Kind of clearing the way. Second power play of the game for either side, and they both belong to Western. Still tied up on the dot. Stallions control. Go to work setting it up top. There's a shot. It's deflected on the way in. Bobulsik made the save, and he's able to track down the rebound. He'll freeze that for a draw to his left. Well, within the ebb and flow, too, of the game, I suppose you know, coming back the other way, too, that if you end up with that call that goes against you if you're Arizona, you probably got one coming back the other way eventually.
Right. They moved this faceoff out of the zone, which I thought was interesting. I thought it was just a frozen puck there, but
I believe the indication from the ref over to the Western bench was that one of the Western Michigan players maybe hand pass, perhaps, was the indication. Not entirely sure. I saw the referee gesturing with his hand. That would be my guess. Either way, they bring it right back in and go to work setting it up. Santa at the right point, feeding it over the left side. Siwula to the left half wall, cycled in deep. Desmond can't get to it, ramped around, but Santa holding at the right point. Santa, right half wall, shot off angle, off the left shoulder of Bobulsik, out of play. Boy, Kozar had that ticketed top corner of the near side. Great shot, better stop.
Yeah, we spoke with Kozar as well before the game, the goal scorer, and picked up an assist last night as well. Definitely a guy who's got a hot stick, you know, and had a great chance there, but Bobulsik did well.
Well, and if you look back at the goal he gave up in the first period, went down a little early, it beat him over the shoulder. Keep shooting high. And maybe Bobulsik, a little aware of that, stayed tall on that one. Western Michigan again setting it up, a shot tipped in front, did not make it on net. And that one escapes right through the skates of Siwula. He has to chase it all the way back down. 45 seconds left to go in the power play. I'm trying to fast forward time here. Ford moving it ahead. Lead pass on the left wing side. Farkas cutting in. Leaves it off in the near circle, ends up at the left point. Siwula drive, and he scores. Corey Siwula absolutely just stepped into that and gave it everything. It finds the net, and a power play goal ties things up here for Western Michigan. It's 2-2.
Sawula's second of the game here, just a snipe there. He's had a great, you know, two-day set as well here. Really great to see, you know, kind of the skill from this Western Michigan team. Obviously, we highlight guys like Ford, but Sawula, the captain of this this team, getting it done on the score sheet.
Boy, he just gave that one everything he had. And Bavalsik looked like he was still kind of coming out to try to front that puck. Ends up beating him.
By number 78, Corey Sawula. Give the assist to number 16, Drew Wada. That's Sawula from Wada. Time of the Stallions power play goal, 10 minutes, 44 seconds in the second period.
So we're back to a tie hockey game here. And Western Michigan trying to keep the momentum for themselves. Wada putting it down to the near corner. Puck behind the net, Hole picks it up for Arizona. He'll feed it to the near side. Hedgecote to center. Sent on down. Westlin challenging, trying to steal it away. Bailey Marshall, left side corner, poked off his stick. And that one is lifted out of play. 8:19 to go in the second. Well, we certainly have more to talk about here in the second period, Will.
Yeah, the kind of more of a neutral zone battle. Not too many scoring chances in that first period. But, Arizona did well to get back in front here. But, again, we talked about that penalty kill and how it's 95%. Well, there is 5% there where they are scoring, and we saw it there. And, eventually if you keep giving them chances and keep kind of shooting yourself in the foot, they're going to take advantage of it.
Faceoff coming up to the left of the Stallions' net. And it ends up at the point, kept into the right side. Here's Larson on the half wall, tried to slide it in front, blocked. Concannon, right point. Throws a hopper towards the net that misses high. Left point, Freiberg keeping it alive. Drifting around to the far hash marks. Larson with a heavy hit on the far wall. And this line picking it up a little bit again. Whenever these guys are on the ice, especially Larson, you can count on a couple of bumps being tossed. Puck goes free back to the Wildcat line, but it's turned right back in. Off the discarded stick in the zone, right side Johansson trying to leave it in the far corner. Dawson Marshall trying to help out in the pile. Scoots to the near side with it. Feeding left point, Rowe looking across, trying to shot blocked, and it comes out of the zone. Rowe battling for it. Gets a little help from his D partner there. Timor moving it back in. Arizona offside, they'll peel out and go for the change. Now stepping right back in, Dawson Marshall, left side, wide on the wing, looking in front, fed through the slot, ends up at the right point. Timor waits, his shot tipped up in the air, comes back down, Arizona. We'll swing it behind the net.
Get out of the way, yep.
And the referee got in the way on that one. Centering attempt, as you heard the helpful call from the fans in front of us. Timor ends up with it. Move it back across, and it's flipped. Well, it did stay in off the glass. Thought that might have ended up at the bench. Rowe pushing down to the right side of the forecheck. And now it's Western Michigan back on its skates a little bit here, but they'll finally get a chance to break the zone. Here's Adams to the stripe at center. He'll dump it in. 6.5 to go in the second. We are tied at 2. That one deflected down, no icing. Chased by Olsen. Olsen throwing the shoulder, and here comes the crowd. A bouncer wide of Bavalsik. He'll knock it down and hang on. Will, I don't mind that play here. Slow it down a little bit. Let your guys get a chance to catch their breath and settle it.
Yeah, just kind of regroup a little bit. Arizona, spent some extended time there in their offensive zone. Western Michigan tonight's doing really great getting some sticks out in front of shots and really making sure that, we saw Timor, we saw a couple guys who really, had some pucks and some good opportunities there to get the puck on net. But Western Michigan doing well to close out those scoring chances.
So now, once again, Arizona will push in offside, however. Oh, boy, that was unfortunate. Just barely over the line. Cully Olsen there as Litwin hit the line with a head of steam, but both skates are in the offensive zone, and that gives us a whistle and a pause here. Not quite 6 minutes left to go in the second period. And now we have, looks like that's Josh Larson, who's heading off. I believe it was Larson who lost his stick and his glove in the offensive zone, and I wonder if he might have taken a hit on that exposed hand.
I think he threw a hit, that's kind of what happened there. And you know, immediately he just went right to the bench. Hope Larson can come back out here because he's had a lot of good shifts for Arizona to kind of get the energy moving.
He has been an energy guy out there for the Wildcats. The injuries continuing to mount for this Wildcat hockey team. And Larson is he's a key guy, as you mentioned. The energy he brings on a shift, goes out, throws a couple of hits, really stirs the pot. But he is heading back towards the locker room right now. And Arizona trying not to give it up in front of their own net. They're moving up the right side. Wildcats trying to press in, almost cutting through. Artizon almost made it through the D there. Beard back out to center. And it's picked away. Swept ahead by Cusinelli. Left side, Artizon feeding it across. Could not connect with Litwin, who crashes into the right corner, took it away from Santa. Litwin on the cycle on the right side. Cusinelli back down to Litwin. Centers and a shot right across the crease. Well, goal light a little premature on that one. As it is sent down, this will be an icing call. Yes. Yeah, a little trigger happy on the goal light there.
Yeah, good chance though. You know, fed right in front there. I'm struggling to try and put it to words here because they are getting good chances, Arizona. But you know, it's just one slight pass away. It's just one tip that's quite not going the right way there. But again, you know, tie 2-2. You like to keep seeing those scoring chances kind of generate. Litwin's doing some great work out there. Has a lot of good shifts today.
You know what I think is hilarious? Are players complaining about the goal light going on? I mean, if you're the goal judge, I imagine sometimes you might hit it by accident.
Right.
You might be reaching for something and accidentally knock the switch and it goes on for a second. You shut it back off. But the fact that it has a couple of guys rattled for Western Michigan, it's like you cannot think about that during the course of a hockey game. Who cares? The puck didn't go in your net. Everyone knows it clearly didn't go in your net. Hand pass whistled down here, 4:45 to go in the second. That's just it's the mental side of the game is kind of where I'm going with this point. It's the mental side of the game, the composure. That is so far away from anything to do with what's going on the ice. Unless you're going to try to, you know, have a conspiracy theory going that teddy bear toss goal didn't actually go in earlier. But I think that ship has sailed. Michigan able to clear it down to the right side. Kozar after it, trying to center. That one was blocked off a shin pad. Con Cannon in the corner, lost it. Here's Ford wrapping it around, tried to put it towards the point. Pass does get to the left point and sent right back down. Bailey Marshall up the left side. It's flung well down the ice to the right side, but Westland's going to beat out the icing. Westland into the corner. Give her a little help from Marshall. Marshall feeds it to the left point to Rowe. Rowe with a rolling puck, puts it back down to Dasher. Backhanded along, pinched off on the wall by Cusinelli. Cusinelli, Marshall in front. Oh, a shot and just getting a piece of it there was Hufford. Right in front. What a great chance for Westland denied. Right back comes Arizona, left point. Rowe dancing, flings it to the far corner. Westland after it. I'm not sure if Hufford made that save or if it hit him, but either way, boy, oh boy, you got just enough of that puck. There's Cusinelli off-angle chance. That one shut off at the far post. And Arizona with some energy, but they turned the puck over. Ford will move it across, and now wedged in on the right-wing side by Wada. And the Stallions change it up. 3:12 to go in the second, tied at 2. Johansson on the rush for the Wildcats. Left wing corner, swings it around to the right side. Timor down from the point. Leaving it off, Bird falls. Puck is still there with him. Clear to the line, not out. Timor sending it back to an open wing. Siwula, who's got 2 goals here tonight for the Western Michigan University Club, able to get that one around. It ends up out at center and tipped into the skates there. A nice recovery by Hedgecoat. Back of the Wildcats again, led by Rowe. Rowe trying to force it off the Dasher, picked it up behind the net. Rowe out the right wing side. the way to the right point. Backing up, swings it over, Hedgecoat through traffic, shot made it on goal, stopped there by Hufford. Stallions the other way. They turn it over at center. Both teams try to take advantage here in a hand pass. That'll be whistled and put the faceoff back into the Arizona zone. 2:04 to go in the second. It's kind of opened up, and if you're a coach on either side, Will, I think you would say not in a good way right now. These two teams just kind of trading chances, and I don't think either coach would necessarily like that.
Yeah, and Arizona there spent kind of some extended time in their offensive zone, generating a lot of chances. We go back to that chance right out in front from Cusinelli to Westland. You want to see a lot more of that for Arizona. They were working the puck pretty well in the offensive zone. Eventually those chances will come.
Wildcats break the zone here. Up the left side, Dawson Marshall chasing the puck. Stepping to Kozar. Sent towards the point. That one cut off, did not get through. And now Kozar moving it ahead. He'll backhand it down. Bivolsek trying to tell Hedgecoat he's got a forechecker on him. Sidesteps him. Puck is kept in from the right point by Santa. Now a couple of shots exchanged with the puck away to center. Dawson Marshall trying to cut through a sandwich there. Got the puck deep. Shot towards the front of the net. Bouncer rolling towards the point. Chop back in front. Ends up on the near wall. Pinching left side. Well, Freiberg peeled off. Dawson Marshall kept it in. Westland centering feed. Shot save made. Hufford right on the doorstep as Meyer was cleaned out. Kept into the right point by the Wildcats. There's a shot. Cusinelli. That one is pawed down. Rebound free in front. Cleared along and out it goes. Pavolsic moving way up, trying to catch Western Michigan in a change. Tip down. Will this be icing? No. Westland just missed finishing his check. Cusinelli at the line, keeping it alive. Bailey Marshall on the right side, waiting for help. Fed it to the slot. No one there. 30 seconds to go. Long pass, stretching it ahead. Cutting into the right side is Farkas. He'll put it into the high slot. A centering feed, maybe looking for Siwula. Turned right out through center. Cusinelli had it deflected away. Adams turning it back in for Western. Cleared around the glass, and the Wildcats get it out. 7 seconds to go in the period. And Arizona will just eat the puck behind the net here. Freiberg steps away. But it got kind of wild at the end of the second period there, Will. Opened right up. We had a couple of goals here in the second period. We're going to leave tied at 2 after 40 minutes of play. A shorthanded goal for Arizona, a power play goal for Western Michigan. And Arizona's yet to have a power play in this game.
Yeah, that's huge from Western Michigan, staying out of the box and you know, not really hurting yourself here on the road. Hufford came up with a couple huge saves there at the end of that period. Again, had kind of one of those rebound chances that Arizona was able to take advantage of yesterday. Western Michigan did a lot better clearing that puck right out, not giving up any second chance scoring opportunities there. But, you know, for Arizona, I think it's a little bit better for you going into the intermission here. I know it's still tied 2-2, and Western Michigan's still bringing the fight right back to them with two goals from Siwula. But I think overall, compared to the first period, they're doing a lot better, creating a lot of scoring chances, those kind of, you know, pucks right out in front with guys sitting there. Hufford's just doing really well, kind of closing out those kind of plays. And Western Michigan, who I was highlighting how well that they were closing down some of the shots and getting their sticks in front of it. I mean, Arizona's kind of taking advantage of some of those opportunities that Western Michigan was doing a great job stuffing out. But now Arizona's kind of getting in their groove offensively. Hufford's just had to come up with a couple big saves. Again, though, from Western Michigan, Sawula's putting in some great games, some great effort here tonight. And for Arizona defensively, I think it's been solid, not necessarily great, but, you know, going towards the other end, I think Arizona, it'll be a lot more fortunate if they're finishing up their plays in their defensive zone, and try and get some of those breakout chances.
Well, the Wildcats and the Stallions have 20 minutes, maybe to settle this one. Who knows if we might see a little extra hockey here tonight. But 40 minutes in the books, we're tied at two, and Max Meyer has both goals for Arizona, and Corey Sewula has both goals for Western Michigan. We'll step aside, take a break. When we come back, second intermission report. This is Arizona Wildcats Hockey.
University of Arizona Hockey has a proud history of more than 40 years. Each year we invite back former Arizona players for an alumni weekend. Here's what they have to say about their experiences as Wildcats.
I'm Jeremy Goltz. I played here in 90 through 94. I was a defenseman here at the U.
Hi, I'm Eric Holden. I played from 95 to 97. I'm a goaltender.
Shane Fossell, 1991 to 1992, and I played goalie.
Just walking in this building, seeing the boys, I feel like I'm an 18-year-old kid walking in here for the first time. It's every year, you know, there's different guys, some guys in, some guys out, but everyone's special, especially last year with Kelly getting his jersey in the rafters. That one was as cool as it gets. But no, these are special, man. I wouldn't miss this for the world.
What's it like to see guys not only you played with, but guys from the spectrum of the 40 years of Arizona hockey, to see them all back here putting on red, white, and blue?
Oh, it's great. I mean, I came up here as a freshman in high school from New Jersey, so some of these guys were my idols until I got on the team myself. This season, we seem to have more guys from my year than we've had in the past, so it's good to see the boys come back out that I used to play with.
Yeah, I mean, it's a huge undertaking every year, and it's great to have the boys come back whenever they can make it. You know, obviously, we'd like to see more join. There's obviously a lot of ex-players that we would love to see come back and be a part of this experience. What is it you remember about your days at Arizona Hockey that sticks in your mind and makes it so special?
I think a couple things. Obviously, you know, you look at the fans. I mean, I remember here last year, I'm rolling in and someone's got a 25-year-old stick that we did at an autograph session. And then obviously, of course, you know, the boys. They're still my best friends in the world. You know, we come back here, we talk about this story, that story, what if we would have done this. So it's just special, man. I mean, I'm sure every university has it, but to me, this one's just it's a little different. The brotherhood is tight here.
You're part of this revival because you're the goaltender coach for the University of Arizona Wildcats. What is it like now to be the teacher teaching young kids that you were once in that role? You were once the kid just trying to learn how to be a college goaltender. What's it like now to be the teacher?
Yeah, I mean, it's a very neat experience being able to look back and look at the game again through their eyes. And we have two outstanding, I think they're the two best in the league, goalies. And I can't say that their success is due to anything I'm doing, but I'm just glad to be a part of it.
Does that give you some satisfaction to develop young players and then see them become Arizona hockey players?
Honestly, it's the ultimate. You know, coaching, we were just talking about, I was just talking with Berman Hoges about it, how coaching is, how tough it is, but how rewarding it is to see young kids, Manny Rowe, Churro, however you say his name, as a peewee, he's here tearing it up. Newfie, you know, Decker, all these guys that, you know, I knew as young men are here in my brotherhood. Representing the jersey that I love and has really kind of pushed me passion throughout my whole hockey run. So no, it's the ultimate, it's the pinnacle. To see those guys win a national championship would be a dream come true.
Does this give you personal satisfaction, even though your playing days are over, to see the team be doing so well?
Yeah, it feels like the good old days. I mean, that's kind of where we left off back in the 90s. So to see them go through the trials that they've had over the years and to come up strong, it's just a big win right now for us.
Bear down, Eric.
It was extremely important. I mean, it was such a great time in my life. I made some great friends we're all still friends today. And looking back on what we achieved back then at the beginning stages of the ACHA, I think it was pretty important groundwork that was being laid at the time.
For Arizona hockey alumni that haven't come back to Tucson to join an alumni weekend, what can you say to them to tell them to come see their old teammates? Meet new teammates that you didn't play with but also played at Arizona Hockey, just that they should get involved?
Hey, they're missing out. I mean, it's every time you come here, man, you know, there's a guy I haven't seen and I walk by him and I didn't recognize him 15 years. I mean, you've seen the guys even away from the rink, but when you're here skating with them in the locker room, it brings it all back. And, you know, we can get the guys back here. We try every year. we got to get them here. It's just an absolute blast, and they put on a good show for us. So, once again, I'm happy to be here, as always.
Lastly, what is it that you want to say to other Arizona Hockey alumni that haven't come back for one of these weekends, they haven't joined the festivities, they haven't done the alumni game? What do you want to say to them?
Boys, you're missing out on all the fun. Come on out. I guarantee you'll have a good time.
Your hockey team. Your Arizona Wildcats. Call 791-4101 for tickets now.
There is no doubt that number 16, Kelly Walker, is the best of the best. Kelly, when I think of you, I think of the love and the commitment and the greatness you achieved here, right on this ice. Kelly and his teammates were 24-0 versus ASU over that four-year stretch. Please direct your attention to the south end of the Tucson Arena as we now reveal the banner honoring Kelly Walker. Please welcome back to the ice of the Tucson Arena, number 16, Kelly Walker.
You guys have a chance to show this town college hockey at the greatest level that you guys play. So I'm just extremely humbled to be here, to be in front of you guys, and to be in front of this whole great arena. And it's a very emotional moment for me. I'd like to thank my girlfriend, Andrea. I'd like to thank my line mates, Corey, Johnny, Johnny Wags, Goltzy, Danny Anderson, certainly Tommy Smith. I want to mention thanks to the great presentation that Tim did for me today. I want to thank Coach Firms. I want to make special recognition to Shane Fossell. And I also like to take recognition for every other player who has played here at the University of Arizona, who's proud to have played for the University of Arizona, and who continues to support this great program going forward and in the future. So guys, thank you so much for the tribute. Thanks for the support. Love you guys. Thank you very much.
Stay right there. We're perfect. We're perfect. Colorado State's on first, guys. Good work.
It's time for another Arizona Wildcat hockey, this or that.
Slap shot or backhand?
Slap shot.
Why?
Not like I can shoot one, but they're a lot harder.
Blondes or brunettes?
Blondes.
Why?
Do it better.
Thank you. I agree. I would have to agree. Let's see. Crosby or Ovechkin?
Crosby.
Why?
Ovechkin is just like not the best defensive player I've ever seen.
Oh, and my I don't think people are going to like that answer.
It's a hot take, I know, but Ovechkin just not the best defensive player. But Crosby, big two-way forward, and I love it.
Got a good, it's a good point. Let's see, Mighty Ducks or Blades of Glory?
Quack.
Hey, why or?
I mean, there's personally, I don't think there's a better hockey movie than the Mighty Ducks. There's three of them. We'll forget about.
Yeah. Well, which one's the best one?
Well, not D2 or D3. It's the first one.
Oh, okay. So just one.
We'll just skip D2 and D3. We can just cut those.
It never happens.
Yeah, we'll just forget about those.
Boxers or Commando?
Boxers.
Why?
I don't know. I'm just not feeling free today.
Oh, so this is just today, not just today. In general? Yeah. Oh, okay. But normally? Boxers still, it's just boxers?
Commando.
Oh, okay.
Here's Bailey Marshall, the star from Central Oklahoma. Back to Cusinelli, the all-everything star for Arizona. Down to Chris Westlund, who sends it in on goal. That's a good idea, and it's right in the slot. And it's a goal for Arizona! I think that's Bailey Marshall. Bailey Marshall, who already had a couple goals last week for Arizona. And that's a big one for the Arizona Wildcats. They even this at 1-1 in the second period. To go in the period. There's a high hard shot. They're just kind of sitting around in the crease. Where's it? It's in the net. That's a goal. Arizona scores the first goal. As the Cats go on the man advantage. Get the puck up behind the blue line. Down low to Cusinelli. Shoot the puck, Anthony. He does. That's a beautiful shot. Shoot the puck. Anthony Cusinelli. Score the goal. Anthony Cusinelli. Arizona takes a 3-0 lead. Wow.
That's an excellent look by Cusinelli. You saw him look for the pass first, but then he was aware. He had a clear shooting lane, and he took it. And he's one of those guys that can put it just where he wants it.
Anthony Cusinelli turns with it. Oh, Nick's shot. It gets tipped in. Anthony Cusinelli just threw it towards the net. And I think Bailey Marshall may have tipped that one in. Up the near side boards. That's come away with it. That's a power of the goal. I'm not sure if that's Justin Plumoff's goal.
I think that might have been Trey Decker. I'm not quite sure, but
I think Decker just threw that in front and it bounced in. There's a nice possession of the puck. That can't happen. Cats come over the blue line. And they shoot, they score! They shoot, they score! Arizona scores! And that puck was given up. We talked about mistakes. Wow, what a mistake right in front of Joshua George. Anthony Cusinelli had a good shot there, but George saw it and made the save. You know, Anthony Cusinelli, I think, just needs to shoot the puck a little bit more like he did there. He switches now to the center of the ice. Take the shot, Anthony. And he shoots, he scores! Anthony Cusinelli! He shoots, he scores!
Great puck movement there by the Wildcats on the power play up top. All right, everybody, welcome back to the Tucson Arena, where Arizona Wildcats and Western Michigan Stallions are tied up at 2, headed into this third period. And after that second period, our own Autumn Freutland caught up with Max Meyer, the goal scorer for both of Arizona's goals. Let's see what he had to say about those.
Hi, I'm Autumn Freutland, and I'm here with number 27, Max Meyer. Max, you were having yourself quite a night. You guys were down one going into the second, but you were able to score two. Both those goals are yours. Talk a little bit about those.
Yeah, I mean, the first one, just a rebound goal, working hard behind the net, and the second one just playing with speed. So I like where we're at right now. I think we're playing a lot better than the scoreboard shows, so I'm pretty happy where we're at going into the third here.
Now, this game is not over yet. It is tied at 2. What are you guys going to have to do in the third to make sure you guys come out on top?
Yeah, I think we just got to keep working hard, and our chances will come. We just got to keep plugging away.
Awesome. We've been speaking with number 27, Max Meyer, and we will send it back up to the booth.
All right. Thank you, Autumn. So Max Meyer scored 2 goals here for both of the Arizona goals here, and then Corey Sawula for Western Michigan has both of their goals. Yesterday we saw all this balanced scoring from the Wildcats, and today, you know, it's only coming from Max Meyer, a guy who, you know, had a lot of energy shifts there. You saw him score shorthanded, working hard, getting up and down. But that energy needs to come from somewhere. We saw Josh Larson kind of go off the ice there, and he was a guy who was putting in a lot of those shifts with a lot of big hits. You hope maybe he can return and provide some of that. But again, kind of feel the Wildcats maybe relying too heavily on that line with Cusinelli and Wesson to try and create something in front.
Well, and that's one thing we'll keep an eye on here is the Wildcats return to the ice. Does Josh Larson return to the ice? Does the energy level return to the ice? And it was a very ebb and flow period, Will. I mean, we saw it at times where the Wildcats look like they're ready to go through a brick wall and go flying up and down the ice, and then there were other times where that just was not the case. So a bit Jekyll and Hyde this evening and maybe this season, I think you could say, for this Wildcat team. But, man, Larson is back out there, so good to see him back on the bench. But at this point, you have 20 minutes in front of you. Just win the period, and you win the hockey game. You battled it to a 2-2 tie to this point. Just got to get one more than the other guys, and you can skate off with a pair of wins here in this weekend series.
Yeah, Western Michigan, again, hasn't gone to the box once this game so far. For 2 periods of hockey playing pretty clean, not, you know, shooting themselves in the foot at all. We'll see if they can keep doing that, because on the road, you know, if you pick up a penalty, that could be a killer. So really well done by them to, you know, not pick up any penalties, not put Arizona on the power play. Again, though, who's going to be that guy for Arizona? Who's going to be the guy to kind of kickstart something? Is there going to be a guy? Maybe a Timor, maybe a Manny Rowe. Again, Cusinelli, Westland, Bailey Marshall, those type of guys always come up big, but will it come from maybe an unexpected place as well?
Well, here's the other thing. It's incumbent on Arizona to put forth the effort to generate those penalties. I mean, you have to make Western Michigan hook you, hold you, need to interfere, or whatever they need to do. And those are things that come from effort, and that's what you have to do to generate power plays. So we're underway here for period number 3. Half a minute gone with the teams tied at 2. Lead pass on the right side. Bailey Marshall couldn't quite catch up with it. Manny Rowe trying to get back to it. Marshall will feed it back to the D. And now it's poked away on the left wing side, stolen away into the corner. And a centering feed, shot hooked just wide of the net there as Farkas directed it past the far post. Rowe put it up the boards. It does get out to center. Backing up with it is Sewula. That'll be punched in around behind the net. Bobolsik to the left wing, Cusinelli able to get it out off of Santa and out of play.
Hey folks, our winner for the Chuck a Puck is Ann Irwin. Ann Irwin, if you're in, get on up.
1:16 into the third here.
T-shirt and tickets for a future game. And also you can stick around after the game to hear from Coach Irwin.
And hopefully Arizona's going to be able to pick it up a little bit here, Will. It's a little flat to start this third period. Pretty much on both sides.
Yeah, you know, tied up at 2. Obviously, you don't want to make any mistakes, but, you know, the chance has got to come from somewhere, especially if you are Arizona trying to push the tempo.
And if you're Western Michigan, that's exactly what you want to do. Jump all over these guys early in this third period, although they turn the puck over in their own zone, but it's poked away at the line, and now a chance at the left side. Moving ahead, here's Santa with a wrist shot. Just getting a piece was Bobolsik. Santa knocked down in the corner over there. It's played up the near side, and maybe now the pace will pick up a little, but rush thwarted by a bouncing puck. Johansson will feed it back. The Wildcats start a change. Cole skating it through center. Dumping in from there. Wildcats change up the D. Dawson Marshall to the near side. A centering feed was blocked. Kept in by Meyer on the right side. Dacker shot, stop, rebound up the slot. A left pad saved by Hufford. Great positional stop there. Puck hooked up the slot again, but taken away by Osen. Move it away towards the Wildcat zone. Decker throwing it back the other way. Tipped out of play off the stick of Ford. Nice couple of chances there, Will, for the Wildcats in the Western Michigan end.
Yeah, Western Michigan just kind of sloppy getting that puck out of the zone there. Arizona did well to keep it in there. You know, Max Meyer just kind of tried to feed it in front and hope someone was there, but much better so far from Arizona too. After the first kind of minute or so, they've settled in and really tried to push some scoring chances.
Wildcats control the faceoff, puck at center, tossed right back in. Babalsik out to leave it. Rowe back to the near side. Timor. Timor's pass. Jacker. Cross ice it. Oh, look out in the Western Michigan bench. Now the whistles kind of kill the ability to really get any flow going here early in this third period.
Yeah, Arizona trying to break out there. You know, unfortunately the puck just kind of went into the bench there. But, it's a little bit of a struggle for them trying to get those breakout plays tonight. Western Michigan doing well to kind of stop those.
Rowe will bank it ahead on the left side. Dawson Marshall chipping it in. Meyer up on the forecheck. Scoots around to the right point. Timor couldn't hold. He will send it back in. Didn't get it deep, though. Bouncer to center. Turn right back over to Marshall. Marshall moving ahead as Meyer with him. And play offside at the Western Michigan blue line. So as it gets a little kind of grindy here in this early first 3.5 minutes, who do you think that favors more, Western Michigan or Arizona?
I think Western Michigan. Arizona's having some difficult time. I mean, obviously they're doing well to bump Western Michigan off any of their kind of breakout plays and any scoring chances they have going the other way. But again, if you're on the road and the longer that this game goes on where it's tied 2-2 and Arizona's starting to get frustrated, that always is going to benefit the road team in Western Michigan.
Hard zone to the left side, trying to pull it free. Out of the pile with it, a bouncing puck, still not out. Arizona ran into Santa. Referee is right there on the wall. Santa onto the near side. And now Stallions break the zone as Sulin able to get it out. No icing back into the Stallion zone. Quickly up on the forecheck there, Olsen. Trying to force a turnover and does. Out of the left side and now right back to Western Michigan. Pass ahead at center. Reese got it too far and that ends up as an icing call. Clearly from Olinger's reaction, he didn't think it was, but face off back into the offensive zone for the Wildcats. At some point, you'd like to see him take advantage, too, of a couple of draws in the O zone.
Yeah, especially on an icing call, too. Something where, maybe you have some tired legs out there for Western Michigan. They have had a lot of those great set plays, though, off the faceoff.
And Marshall trying to move it free. Bailey Marshall on the right side slips through a check but couldn't hang on to the puck. Out it goes. Hedgecoke back after it. The right wing side, his pass, no icing. Siwula sent it right back up off the ref, it stays in. Cusinelli in the slot, his shot tipped up in the air, glove down in front. Onto the near side, Zappa, cross ice feed, picked up by Kozar. And that is tossed right back out to center by the Wildcats. Now on the right side, trying to move up. Westland driving into the wing. Nice job there by Adams to wrap him up on the wall. Cusinelli feeds it across. Freiberg through the slot, nobody there. Cusinelli holding it in on the right side. Siwule able to get it out to center, a little too far for Zappa. Right back off the glass and out for Arizona. Desmond trying to move it ahead. Pass picked off, turning the other way. Up on the forecheck is Lowell. laid to the near wall. Lowell finishes his check. On come the Stallions. Left side, Osen. Try to slide it up top at the back of the net. Carams to the near side, and a shot fought off by Bowalsik with the glove. That wrist shot there for the near side. Again, Barry trying to go high. Maybe Western Michigan thinking that's the book on the big netminder. Larson goes in, throws a hit. That's the presence we were talking about out there. Good to see him back out. Here comes another one. Josh Larson takes a run at his man in the corner. Puck stays in right point. Shot, Tibor, rebound up the slot is cleared out. And that's what those hits do. When that guy's on the ice, Western Michigan's looking over their shoulder. Back into the right side. Johansson tried to wrap it in front. That one is knocked away by Hufford at the near post. When guys are looking behind them when they hear those footsteps, it's a different attitude out there. Bowalsik playing it away to center. Johansson lost it to Skates. Ward played it all the way back down to his goalie, who elects to just cover it and slow it down a bit.
Some pretty big saves there from Hufford on that kind of flurry of chances that were all generated from Josh Larson. And we, you know, we mentioned it at the top of the period here. It absolutely huge to have him back in this game after having to take some time off with kind of nursing a possible injury there. And, you know, it all starts with the guys like that. It all starts with the energy shifts. And like you said, it keeps the puck in the zone and it keeps Western Michigan on their toes. You know, when you hear guys coming for you, you got to be ready to absorb checks. And for Larson, it's really a good job setting the tone for maybe the rest of the team to kind of start throwing some as well.
Hand pass against the Stallions. Faceoff will come back in the Western Michigan zone. And it is. That's when you're going back for a puck. Now you're looking, and you're more worried about the guy coming at you than setting up the breakout. And it works at all levels of hockey. I mean, there's no big secret to it. No one likes to get hit. They like to throw the hit. Puck in from center. Wildcats try to go back in after it. Bend to the left point. Scooted down the wall by Meyer, but that one is sent right back out to center. Glove down, Ford to his left side, trying to leave it up top. Backdoor feed goes off the heel of a skate, and now Meyer turning it back quickly. They've got numbers if they hurry. Max Meyer driving in the left wing side, trying to feed it past Santa, and Dawson Marshall couldn't get to it. Turns back for it on the half wall. Send it deep, Meyer. Off the toe of his stick, can't chase it down, but kept in by Hole at the right point. Now it's cleared out as Hole knocked down Kozar. Teams are changing it up here. Coming up on 8 minutes gone in the third, tied at two. Corey Siwula, both goals for Western. Max Meyer, both goals for Arizona. Wildcats up, right wing, back in front, and the pass just missed Cusinelli. Now Freiberg in for the point, blocked out in front, a backhand try wide, another chance in front. On the rebound, left side is Westland. We get a whistle though, and a penalty coming up against Bailey Marshall. Or is it? No, this one's gonna go against Western Michigan, pardon me. And it is a cross-checking call, so that first power play of the night finds Arizona not quite halfway through this third period.
If you're Arizona, you got to take advantage of this. This might be your only power play of the game here, and you know, a flurry of chances there generated by Cusinelli and Westland and Bailey Marshall, and you know, those are the guys where in a tight game like this, you're looking for that line to step up.
So Kozar into the box with a cross-checking call. Bailey Marshall in the near corner, feeding it. Johansson tried to stuff it back up top, right point bouncer held down by Hole. He'll get it to the left side. Cross-ice feed, Marshall at the dot. Quick shot, score! Bailey Marshall with a wrist shot from the near face-off circle. A power play goal for the Wildcats. And they're in front 3-2.
Well, take advantage of it, they did. And for Bailey Marshall, a guy who, you know, has kind of had some limited minutes yesterday, great to see him pick up a goal there. Just a great scoring chance created there on the power play. Puck movement was great. Hole did well keeping that puck in the zone to keep that play kind of moving. And then the puck cross ice pass there to Bailey Marshall. Great to see him get on the score sheet.
And a good point. Holt did start that thing off by keeping it in at the right point, keeping the play alive.
Arizona Wildcat Holt giving the number 11, Bailey Marshall. The assist goes to number 13, Matthew Holt. And number 15, Anthony Cusinelli. That's Marshall from Hole and Cusinelli. Time of your Wildcat power play goal, 8 minutes, 31 seconds in the third period.
But now the Wildcats are going to go shorthanded again, and now more pushing and shoving on the near side. And Jonathan Adams skating away from Josh Larson. But right as soon as they take the lead, the Wildcats shorthanded with a holding call here. Well, wait a minute. Maybe not. Is it? No, this is going against Western. I thought he had pointed at one of the Arizona players. Wait, do we have two? No, now we're getting extra penalties out of the deal. Okay, so Larson into the box.
Looked like Brennan Olson headed there as well, and then Corey Sawula for Western Michigan. Both the goals there for them. Captain of the team, a guy who's had a great two-game series here. You know, obviously when you're on, you never want to go down a man, but he's a huge guy to have in the box.
So Olson in for Western, and I think maybe Larson and Olson cancel out here in this. So I guess the hold was against Sawula. I thought it was actually going to be against Lowell. Find out what the call will be here, but Wildcats back to the power play.
Sawula, 2 minutes holding. Western Michigan penalty on number 11, Brennan Olson. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. Wildcat penalty on number 6, Josh Larson. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. All penalties at 9 minutes, 1 second in the third period.
So yeah, that was just Larson and Olson with a little tete-a-tete there, and the initial call on the hold against Sawula, and Arizona comes back in to set it up. Here's Marshall, who's got the power play goal. Wildcats have a 3-2 lead, trying to extend that here. And Marshall getting it down the right side wall. Johansson trying to step around to check, getting it into the high slot. Cusinelli feeding it over, off-angle chance, and the save by Hufford with the right pad. Marshall feeding it over to the left point. Fake shot, Cusinelli down low in the slot. Shot, and Johansson ripped it wide. Hufford without his goal stick. Johansson up top, hole. Looking, feeds it, back door again. And a chance in front, off the skate, and Johansson cleared to the line, and down it goes.
You know, no goal scored there, but I was watching Johansson that entire shift. He was bothering Hufford.
And back in Cusinelli on the backhand, cross ice feed. Meyer couldn't find the handle. And it's fired up to the high slot, not out. That one is held in at the cost of a little stinging palm there for Manny Rowe. Lowell feeds it, slot, backhand pass blindly to the corner by Timor. Picked up, moved behind the net. Johansson out the near side, spins, tried to drive it back in front. He's the only guy left out there from this first power play unit. Now we'll get a chance to get onto there as the puck skated out by Western. Turned over at the line and not cleared the rest of the way. But great pressure by Arizona on this man advantage, which has absolutely flown by. They lead at 3-2, coming up on 9 minutes to go here in this third period, and Western has killed it off. They swing it around the wall, and oh boy, almost a too many men call there, but good heads up play right there. When you hop onto the ice, Matthews knew the puck was coming, didn't touch it, let it go by, and you avoid the call that way. Back into the Wildcat zone. Timor trying to step up. We are skating 5-on-5 here. 8.5 to go into third. And now a chance. Here's Ford in on goal. Bavolsic save. Puck is in behind him. But the whistle went. Oh, the whistle. Saving the Wildcats there. Bavolsic made the save on Ford. And it ended up behind him. We could clearly see it, but we also heard the whistle go. And so it stays 3-2 Arizona.
referees maybe bailed out Arizona there. That puck was sitting there, and Western Michigan came in and crashed the net and really put it in there. Again, though, right after your power play expires, Western Michigan going the other way with Wyatt Ford getting a great scoring opportunity. But, you know, Arizona had a lot of bright spots on that power play. Again, Johansson was right in front of Hufford that pretty much that entire shift he had, and he was bothering him and getting some good scoring chances that way. I'd like to see Arizona kind of keep up the pressure, get some hits, make sure you're finishing all your checks.
Draw to the right of the Wildcats goal. Quick shot on goal, save made, but Balsik rebound goes into the far corner. Western is beginning to push. Freiburg trying to clear, cut off behind the net. Ford on the right side, gets it back in front, tried a quick shot, blocked by traffic. And now Arizona flipping it. No, not out. Ford keeping it into left side. Heavy hit by Freiburg. That was from behind, and Freiburg is going to go to the box for that one. And I think that was Wada that he caught. Wada still down, taking his time getting up here. Looks like he's all right. It's just taking him a sec, gather himself. But Freiburg clearly caught him in the back on that one. Hopefully this is only 2 minutes for Arizona. It is. What do they call it? Boarding or checking from behind.
Huge penalty kill here coming up for Arizona, obviously. You know, 8 minutes left in the game, and we've talked about it so often, but you know, it'll be on display here what they can do.
2 minutes for boarding. Time of that penalty, 11 minutes 58 seconds in the third period.
Boarding indeed. And Western to the power play as they will go to work setting it up. Here's Siwula up top. He's got the power play goal for Western. In fact, he has both goals for him, one at even strength as well. Kozar feeding it down, getting it back near dot cross ice. There's a chance in front. Bobalsik the save, rebound away to the far wall. Bobalsik's been sharp here in the third. Siwula, middle of the blue line. Over to the left side, Kozar getting it back up top. Siwula right side, one-time slap pass into the slot, tipped away. And a broken stick on the play. Siwula's going to delay up the line. Left side, he'll get it down. Kozar back up top. Siwula shot through traffic, didn't make it. Now there's a chance and a right pat save. Bobalsik on the low wrister from Kozar. Siwula getting it back across. Bouncing puck forward, just slaps it around the wall. Kozar, left half wall, Zappa up top. Siwula back to Zappa. Top of the near circle, drive! And that one missed the net. Around it wraps, Ford will keep it in. He cuts along the blue line to his left. Gets it down low, now back up top. Chance into the slot on the backhand, and a blocker. Save Bobalsik on Zappa. Puck is still not out. Fed up top shot, and Siwula missed the net. Another chance, side of the goal, diving out to hold it. And Bobalsik gets a mitt on it.
Well, you had mentioned how great Bobalsik's been playing here in this third period. Really well done by him to just kind of cover up, get a whistle, because Western Michigan was kind of having their way there, moving the puck wherever they wanted, and getting some good scoring chances there as well. You know, Bobalsik did well. Just get a whistle, get your guys off the ice, get some fresh legs in there.
Just under half a minute to go in the boarding penalty against Freiburg. Boy, this would be a huge kill if Arizona can get through this remaining half minute. 6:29 left in the third, 3-2. Wildcats in the lead, and they are able to clear it out off the faceoff. Siwula unable to hold it in. He's pressured by Dawson Marshall out there with brother Bailey. As it's cleared to center, and now attacking on the right side, Western into the Wildcat zone, but turned over. Bailey Marshall will send it back. Siwula slapping his stick on the boards as he gets to the bench. Frustrated as Wildcats have killed it off. Well, Will, now it's basically 6 minutes of what do you have in the tank here? Here come the Wildcats. Dawson Marshall leading it up the left side, trying to put it back in front, and a diving block of the pass. Now 2-on-2 the other way for Western. Cutting in the right side is Ford. Weaving wide, carries behind the neck. Tried to wrap it around, but lost it. He'll feed it up high and fed it out of the zone. Western regrouping. They'll try the left side into the Arizona end. Stolen away and back the other way. Here's Olson trying to cut along the wall. Almost skipped through the check. Pretty close to getting through it there. And that one is cleared back out. And now a race up the left wing side. And a chop at it. Puck still drifting in on goal. And that is swung wide on the backhand by Matthews. Great hustle there. Now a centering feed, a bouncing puck. Matthews letting it go towards the left point, ends up with it. Gets it across to the right side. Wrist shot. That one blocked in front. Another chance set high. Boy, right there, Cully Olson selling out to block it. Another chance. That one missed the net as well. Western can't find the rectangle right now. There's a chance in, and this time they do. And Kowalczyk absorbs it in the chest. 4:33 to go in the third. Arizona 3, Western Michigan 2.
Western Michigan really pressing here, really doing well, bothering Arizona there in their own end. And, you know, if you're Arizona, they're kind of scrambling there defensively. And you know, we highlight so how well the, you know, the goalie play is and how well they are defensively. You know, Western Michigan's putting together a couple of really good shifts here, really trying to get that tied up.
There's a shot tipped on a play, 4:28 to go. Well, that power play goal looms large here in the third period for Arizona. They do kill off the most recent Western Michigan chance. And there's a diving block by Cousinelli, who's a little slow to get up, but he'll skate it off. Puck is behind the Arizona goal. And chipped in front, bouncing dangerously in the slot. Pulled out of there by Bailey Marshall. Cousinelli calling for a change. That shot block clearly bothering him a little bit there. That'll leave a nice little Made in Canada label on his leg. Don't know where to put the ice pack later. Icing against Arizona. So Larson is out there right now, taking Cousinelli's spot on this line with Bailey Marshall and Chris Westland. Western controlling the draw. Marshall blocking the shot that came in from the point. Zappa can't hang onto it. Chipped up the wall by Hole. And Larson trying to move it out. And I'll tell you what, if anybody deserves a crack with this line, I think it is Larson the way he's played in this game.
Yeah, he's provided a good spark for Arizona. We mentioned it with the hitting and just overall energy he has brought to every shift he really has been out there on. Good to see him out there with Westland and Bailey Marshall, that top line.
Hole trying to backhand it away off the glass. It goes out of play. And they say deflected out off a Western player, so the faceoff comes outside the line. Wildcats will scramble the lines up here. Stallions do likewise. 3:26 to go in the third. Well, we got a hockey game on our hands, Will. Started slowly enough. The opening 20 minutes, you could be forgiven for thinking this might have been a bit of a snoozer, but it's gotten much better.
Yeah, really quality hockey by both teams, too. You know, creating a lot of good scoring chances. You know, long extended times of possession of puck in each other's zones. And, you know, for Arizona, they got to be really gritty here and really close this one out.
There's a shot coming in. Oh, just swatted away. Wada was like a shark circling there, saw the puck coming towards him, and it was just slapped out of his reach. Puck into the high slot, and that actually drifts past two Western players and out of the zone. We'll begin to keep an eye on Alex Hufford as well. 3 minutes left. I don't think you see him go yet. Probably a minute and a half. But we'll keep an eye on him just in case. Western trying to step into the Wildcat zone. Puck free, and that one is taken away, cleared to the line, and just over. Nice job there, Dawson Marshall, battling it out, but right back in come the Stallions. There's a wrist shot, Bobalsik the save, rebound behind the net. 2.5 to go in the third. Play to the left point, Siwula backing along the paint. His shot is blocked, and it goes out off of Lowell. Arizona trying to keep them short now, make sure there's fresh legs out there at all times. Western trying to push back in. They're trying to keep their best players out there. And now here's a puck stolen, cutting in front, a shot of that one. Just wide of the net. Decker tried to center it again, and it's cleared away. Boy, a big giveaway right there. Trey Decker had a great chance, but he was shut down by Hufford. 1:52 and counting in this third period. Arizona 3, Western Michigan 2. Bouncing puck finds its way around, kept it at the left point. Shot through traffic, didn't make it. In on goal, and now 3-on-1, maybe 4-on-1 for Western. Santa up, feeds it, backdoor pass way too hard, goes off the stick into the corner. Here's Santa after it. And now fed over to the right side, one time, unable to take the shot. Bouncing puck comes wide to the near side. Matthews chasing it down, trying to feed it towards the point, but it's wedged out by the Wildcats. 1:17 to go in the third. Will Hufford leave the net on this rush? Not yet. Puck turned over to the Wildcats. Bailey Marshall will backhand it along. Knocked away from Cousinelli, but again, the Wildcats pick it up. Here's Westland on the right side, and he'll just grind it down the right wing. Now tries to slip free, a shot. Hufford the save, and he holds a rebound. Marshall was looking for it in front, but there was nothing there. 58.3 seconds to go. Arizona up 3-2, and they've got a face-off in the offensive zone. So yet again, Western will not be able to get the goalie to the bench right away.
Yeah, and that's pretty huge. Obviously, not being able to put an extra guy out there. Only 58.3 seconds left. Western Michigan going to use their timeout right here as well. I just want to highlight kind of some grittier shifts here from Arizona. Throwing bodies right in front of shots. We saw it from Cousinelli. Bailey Marshall's been doing that as well. A lot of these guys really just kind of going for broke and throwing their bodies in front of these shots. But then on the other side too, the ones that are getting through, Pavalsic came up huge with a couple of saves here that he really had to do well with, and he has.
He's a big guy, and when he comes out on the angle, stay square to the shooter, he takes away an awful lot of net. The shots that have beat him have gone up high. And maybe that's a little bit of the book that Western has seen, because it seems like they're trying to shoot high, but they're also missing shots when they do that. And so that's also a nice reflection on the defense for Arizona, clogging up the shooting lanes. And whether it's blocked or whether it sails wide, that's pressure off your goaltender.
Right, and we did see that kind of 3-on-1, maybe possible, like 4-on-1 breakout chance there for Western Michigan. And, the puck kind of just like hopped over the stick there of the skater. And puck kind of was put on a dime there, as far as like it was kind of laced to him. But unfortunate for Arizona to not give up a huge scoring chance there. Western Michigan had a great opportunity to tie this thing up there.
And so timeout over. 58.3 seconds to go into third. Arizona 3, Western Michigan 2. Draw to the left of the Stallions net. 5-on-5, and Arizona wins the draw. That'll buy him more time. Tied up in behind the net. Centering feed knocked away. Westland hustling over to the wall. Puck skated ahead by Western. They lose it, but bring it in onside. There goes the goalie to the bench. 6-on-5 now with the net empty. 40 seconds to go for Western Michigan. They try to stuff it in front. That one is blocked, comes behind the goal. A chance for Arizona here. They'll flip it down towards the empty net and wide for an icing. Well, it looked like Manny Rowe thought he had a better chance of that one, but the puck never really did quite settle on him. He tried to fire it down there anyway, and it skips wide. So the faceoff will come to the right side of Pavalsic with 27.4 seconds to go. Western Michigan net is empty, and they can't win the faceoff. A couple of critical draws that the Wildcats have come up with, but the puck doesn't leave the zone. Shot in front, tipsy, Pavalsic rebound through the slot, ends up in the far circle. Arizona, another chance to send it down the ice. That one is gloved down by Siwula. Siwula will skate it right back in, cutting into the right wing. A shot, Pavalsic the save, he'll hang on. And get a whistle with 6.4 seconds to go.
So we were looking for that hat trick there. Has both the Western Michigan goals. Just 6.4 more seconds left in this game. Arizona's got to just bear down here and really try and close this one out.
Draw to the left of the Wildcat cage. And they win yet another huge draw. Send it around the rim, puck to the line. Tied up, not out, shot in front, tipped away, that'll do it. The Wildcats hold on for a big 3-2 win here on Teddy Bear Toss Night over the Western Michigan University Stallions.
Western Michigan with 12, Arizona with 12 for the game. The
Max Meyer with two goals, including a shorthanded marker. Bailey Marshall, the power play goal that goes for the game winner at 8:31 of the third period. And it negates the effort by Corey Siwula, who had both goals for Western, and the two teams shake hands at center ice, but that is a big, big win for Arizona. As you mentioned, even though it's not a conference game, still a tough opponent, and one that you want to be able to beat. And so the Wildcats able to come up with a big-time victory here, and I'll tell you what, Will, that one's going to feel better in the locker room. As the game went on, I think the second period was better, and then the third period was better for Arizona.
Yeah, you know, that one, being down 1-0 in the first period, and, you know, we talked about their consistency and how they've kind of been able to just close out games that maybe they haven't played very well in. I do think overall the effort in general was better today. But again, still a lot of things they can fine-tune here. 13-2-2 now for Arizona. We'll see, you know, kind of where they go from here. As far as do they fine-tune some of those things. So, you know, it's one of those things, too, for Arizona. They picked up two huge wins. They got the home sweep against Western Michigan, and credit to them, they really played well here.
And so now it looks like, we'll get our player of the game perhaps first here. And it looks like it's going to be Max Meyer.
Hi, I'm Autumn Freudland, and I'm joined by number 27, Max Meyer. Max, obviously you guys were down one headed into the second, but you were able to score twice tonight. Talk a little bit about those goals.
Yeah, I mean, I think they just come from competing hard, and overall I think I'm pretty proud of the team, the way we played tonight. You know, we worked hard and grinded out a nice win.
Now, obviously, teamwork is super important. How do you feel the team played overall, and talk a little bit about how hard work in every single period is vital to win these games?
Yeah, I mean, we talked about it before the game, and we've been working on it all year, and we made it a priority tonight to work hard and just capitalize on our chances.
Awesome. We'll be speaking with Max Meyer. Congratulations on a great win.
So, you know, Tom, two wins here, kind of some shaky games all around for Arizona, but they were able to pick up two wins. Kind of the keys, I think, was that balanced scoring yesterday. Today we saw Max Meyer put in a couple good shifts. And then again, Bailey Marshall there picked up that game winner on the power play. A lot to really take away from here from these two games.
Well, Will, the most important thing is the W, and they do come out with a couple of wins on the weekend. This was a tough series. And, you know, some of it is, and from the Arizona side, you can say, well, we need to be better here, here, and here. But, hey, Western Michigan's a good hockey team. I know the record doesn't necessarily reflect it, but they're a tough team They can play physical. It is difficult when they're trapping up in the neutral zone and they're really, you know, just kind of blocking your flow through. It's something you have to work around, and you have to focus, and you have to stay disciplined to beat. You can get frustrated by it. And Arizona, for the most part, did not get frustrated by this team. So, yeah, a couple of great outings from the goaltenders certainly helped as well. Special teams was big, especially tonight. Shorthanded goal for Max Meyer, and then power play goal for Bailey Marshall. Really nice to see the Wildcats come out with the W.
Yeah, and some credit here for Western Michigan, who came in on the road and pretty much only played one really poor period of hockey out of six. That first period in that first game, that 3-0 lead that we had talked about. So credit to them. And again, Wyatt Ford, a guy who we had highlighted, one of the best goal scorers and just scoring chance creators in the ACHA. 0 points in these two games. Really well done by Arizona to make sure that he didn't hurt them. And again, let's go back to what kind of is the backbone of this team. Goaltending, but also came up with a couple big saves today.
Yeah, Ford had a great chance breaking in from his left to his right. Bavalsik stayed with him and cut across, made a big save. Ford had a couple of chances, but not as many as maybe I thought his point total would merit. So yeah, they did a nice job of marking him defensively, making sure they took his chances away. So that also goes a long way towards helping you win some hockey games. And you know what, at the end of the day, it's nice to see both goaltenders get out there, get starts, quality starts, play well, make some big saves, and get a couple of wins.
Yeah, and so for Hufford, a guy on Western Michigan who really did play well, had a couple of rebound chances there that Arizona was able to take advantage of in that first game. But, you know, a credit to him as well. He was able to kind of settle in and really caused a lot of problems for Arizona and was able to stop a lot of scoring chances from them. And for Arizona, again, those consistency issues is something we've talked about. But the one thing that is pretty consistent, they're able to close out games when they do have a lead. We saw it again here today and tonight. Did really well with the last 6 minutes or so, giving up a penalty and then closing out the game with the empty net.
Well, you know, that big penalty kill that we talked about, I mean, not only, you know, kind of highlight the shorthanded goal, but that takes a lot of effort, and they did a nice job against the Western power play here. And you know what you do? You have to dig down. Guys were diving, blocking shots. Olsen, Cousinelli, Marshall, those guys were hitting the deck, getting in front of pucks, you know, laying out for their goaltender as well. And they were forcing a lot of times Western shots either wide or they were blocked off in the traffic. And I thought that was, you know, a really good job by the Wildcats to get into those lanes. And especially even with their sticks, maybe, if not their bodies, to be able to have to, you know, make Western take those extra couple of strides, make them have to change the angle, move a couple of feet. That gives your goaltender time to get over and get set and make those saves. When he's square to the puck, he's going to stop them.
Yeah, and so 2-0 for Arizona, was able to sweep this homestand. They'll be back next week with a Thursday and Saturday series against UNLV, a UNLV team that is very strong, ranked in the top 25. It'll be a tough test for Arizona again here at home. So we hope to see you guys here on Thursday and as well on the Facebook and YouTube broadcasts. So for all of us here at the Arizona media team, for Will Harmon, Tom Callahan, thank you so much for watching the University of Arizona Wildcats hockey.
Thank you for watching University of Arizona Wildcats hockey. Visit our website at arizonawildcathockey.org, and we'll see you at the Tucson Arena for the next Arizona Wildcats home game.